from Tot Stadium in Newport News. WHCS Cable Channel 5 presents Group AAA Division 5 State Championship Game. The Hampton Crabbers and the EC Glass Hilltoppers. Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Todd Stadium. I'm Tim Cole along with Bob Hintz. We are here for the championship game between the 12-1 Hampton Crabbers and the 11-2 EC Glass Hilltoppers. Bob, this game, of course, is for all the marbles. We've got weather conditions that aren't ideal, to say the least, but at least the field, in spite of all the rain, the field seems to be in pretty good shape.
Well, they called for rain all morning, and we didn't get it all morning, so that really is a blessing in disguise. It is. It's soggy. It's not as bad as last week's field, as you and I know. But, Tim, this is going to be a great, great contest. These teams started practice first week of August. We're talking 5 months to get to where they are today. And every day of practice, and they had 2 days when it was so daggone hot they couldn't hardly stand it, the thing that was in their mind was this game today, the state championship.
Well, the Hampton Crabbers defeated only one time. That was the opening game in conditions that were not ideal either. It was a lot warmer, but it was very wet. And, of course, those of you that recall, Kickitan won that game 12-8. The Hampton Crabbers were driving. They were on the one-yard line when time ran out. That's the only blemish on a perfect record for the Crabbers. On the other side, EC Glass has not lost on the field of play. Now, they're 11-2, but they had to forfeit two games because of ineligible players or player, singular, I guess it is. But in any event, they have not lost on the field, and they are a very strong team defensively.
Oh, they really are. They have not given up many points at all year long. The most points they've given up to any teams has been in the playoff. So, you know, when you hit the playoff, you're going to run into caliber teams that can put points on the board, and they realize that. They come in with a lot of confidence. But, Tim, if you even remember back in 1992, you and I went up to Lynchburg, and we did a game between EC Glass and Bethel High School, and their quarterback got hurt in the first half of play, and a young man come in, and we called him Brooks all night because there was nothing on the roster, number 17. It was this young man, Andre Kendrick, who was playing for them. He's a senior. He's 5'8". He reminds you a lot of Allen Iverson in that he tries to scramble a lot, and he throws and he runs the ball a lot. So I don't know if that he tried to emulate Allen from watching him in that game, but he is really in fact, the people up in the Northwestern say he's the best quarterback in the state. I don't think they've seen Ronald Curry yet.
No, they haven't, and we will get a chance to watch these two premier quarterbacks battle each other this afternoon. Of course, Ron Curry's story is well documented. Young man has just been phenomenal, just a sophomore. He's passed for over 1,700 yards, rushed for more than 800, but these are similar statistics to Kendrick. Kendrick comes into this game with almost identical statistics, a little better pass completion, but he has also doubled the interceptions that Curry has thrown. Curry with 4 INTs, 3 of those late in the season now, and then Kendrick with 8 INTs. But the Hilltoppers come in here having given up no more than 6 points in 8 of their 13 games.
Yeah, and you have to look at both programs. And I went back and did some research, and Mike Keach had a nice article in the paper about it. But Mike Smith was an assistant under Johnny Palmer when Johnny was coaching at Hampton. When he left, Mike got the job. Johnny went up to EC Glass. One of his assistants was Bo Henson. So you have two programs that came from basically the same man in Johnny Palmer. Was a great coach, but he was laid back. These two coaches are not laid back. They're both very fiery. They're very excited about their team. And, you know, you talk to Mike Smith about Ronald Curry, and he just bubbles. I mean, he knows he's going to have the young man for 2 more years, but he says 3 A's and 3 B's on his report card, and he's probably doing better now. He says just a great student and athlete and young man that you'd love to call your son.
But now, without making this too lengthy, I also want to make mention of that these are not one-dimensional teams. These guys have good quarterbacks, but they also have a great supporting cast. The Hilltoppers have one young man who rushed for better than 1,000 yards, another one right at 900 and some yards. Of course, the Crabbers have Chris Ricks, who broke the 1,000-yard mark, and they've got Smith, and they've got a well-balanced team. As we saw last week, when Ronald Curry was not as effective as he has been in some games, these two guys stepped it up and came in and ran for about 100 yards apiece.
Well, see, and Mike knew that they could run against that team. So that was their game plan. Against Deep Creek, he knew he could pass. He came out passing. But they have so many attacks that they can come at you. They can come at you with the run, with the pass. They've got a great defense. And I think their secondary is probably the best secondary in the state. You take the three deep men for Hampton. I think there may be other teams that have a good player, but not three real good ones in McKenzie and Curry and Hawkins. Those three young men will just eat up a quarterback if he doesn't get the ball right on the money.
Now, we were talking about the defensive prowess of the Hilltoppers. They also score points. They average better than 35 points a game, very similar to Hampton. So we've got very mirrored teams here as far as what they do on the field. The Hampton defense, however, and I've saved this for last, has really been the big factor in this season.
Oh, there's no doubt in my mind that the defense led by, and you can't say led by because everybody steps up, but Hollier's doing a great job. Donnie Green's doing a great job. The linebackers, the defensive ends, I mean, they just all work as a unit. They use a workmanlike approach to every game. They've got a job to do. They go out and do it. And I tell you, they're ready for today's game.
And so are we. I've even got the same outfit on for the fourth week in a row now. And Mike Smith has followed a little bit of superstition. He didn't want to talk to us today because things have kind of gone well the last couple of weeks. He was unable to those
situations. Well, he would have talked to us. I mean, he talked to us, but not on camera.
Right. He did not want to be interviewed necessarily. You get into these things about superstition, and they become a factor. So we don't have the coaches' interviews, but we've got one great game coming your way. And we're going to be right back with the starting lineups for today's championship game from Todd Stadium after this brief timeout. Tim Cole and Bob Hitz back at Todd Stadium. Tonight's game is brought to you through sponsorships of the following: Zoom's Sitco with five friendly Hampton locations, by Hampton Chevrolet in Hampton, by Forbes and Broadwell, attorneys at law, along with Lifeline Fitness Center.
Gearing up for your next print job, call Gear Up.
And in part by Wood Funeral Home, where the funeral director is Richard Pulley. There is your referee for today's game. That's Andy Keel. And he will be meeting at the center of the field with the officials and the team captains. Do we have a microphone on Mr. Keel?
I think so.
Okay.
Yeah, I see it on his belt.
Great. All right. Well, these officials, by the way, are from the Central Virginia Football Association. There you see Andy Keel. Your umpire is Dalton. Fagan is the line. Steve Wade is the line judge. The field judge is Chip Hurt. And the back judge is George Lewis. And if you'll notice, there are six officials.
Use it. Okay. Could you hear me before?
Yes. We are being asked by the referee if we can hear him. Yes, we can.
We're loud and clear. And we do appreciate that. And we know sometimes the other officials don't like it. You can see the three captains from EC Glass coming across.
Bradley, number 77. Kendrick, number 1. And number 20 is Chris Matthews. There you see for the Hampton Crabbers. From left to right, it's
Kendrick.
Donnie Green.
Captain Kendrick, stand right here, please.
Number 9 is Hawkins. And of course,
come on, fellas. Who's the talking captain over here?
The toss of the
okay,
coin.
You're Captain Carey, right? Okay, captains, introduce yourselves. Okay, men, we'll call you red today. We'll call you white. You're the visiting team. I want you to call this coin in the air, heads or tails, call it so that everybody can hear it, Captain Carriage. If I drop it, we do it again, all right? Tails.
Tails or calls?
You call tails, and it is a heads. You have won the toss, Hampton. Would you like to defer, receive, kick, or defend?
Receive.
Say again?
Receive.
You want to receive. Which goal do you want to defend? All right, men, would you turn around, place your backs to your goals? Hampton, you have won, and you will receive. Bring your teams out.
All right, we want to thank referee thank Andy Keel for allowing us to listen in on the toss of the coin. As you heard, Hampton will be receiving. They'll be going from our right to our left. Now, there is a very stiff breeze, but I don't know exactly how this will ultimately affect the passing, if at all. The breeze is going across the field and a little bit towards the right end zone, but it's a very consistent wind. And we've already seen Ronald Curry in very adverse conditions in Deep Creek. Had no problem passing at all.
No, he really hasn't, Tim. And the only thing that it may affect, I was watching their team warm up. They have a field goal kicker. He can kick the ball well. He's got to kick it to the right if he's headed towards the scoreboard, because the wind is going to bring it back to the left some.
You saw Mike Smith there. You see him on your screen. Let's give you the lineups if we can for both of these squads. The Crabbers on offense.
There you see Adam Lively is a center. Groggins and Massenburg, the guards. Green and Marcus Smith are the tackles. The tight end is Bobby Blizzard. Split in Kenny Crawford. The flanker and Maud Hawkins. The fullback, Darryl Smith. Tailback, Chris Rickson. Quarterback, Ronald Curry.
Those are the Hampton Crabbers on offense. Of course, they will receive. On defense for the Hilltoppers, Bradley and Smith are the tackles. Spencer and Anthony will play the ends. The linebackers, the Lemelure, Wynn, and Brown. And the deep end will be Vereen, McDaniel, Johnson, and the safety is Tucker. And there is the blue and white side of the field. That is the crowd for the Hilltoppers out of Lynchburg. E.C. Glass. Last time E.C. Glass played a Peninsula team, there you see the Hampton side. Last time they played a Peninsula team, they were thrashed by Allen Iverson and the Bethel Bruins. So that's something I'm sure they remember vividly. All right, the placemaker, Jeff Burke, has the ball teed up. And his kick is a short one.
And it was an offside. They were offside on the kickoff.
And it went out of bounds as well, so there would be two separate penalties. I believe the offsides probably was whistled and waved before the ball even got kicked, so it automatically back up.
And you kind of expect that. There's a lot of emotion. You want to get down there, get the first hit in, and in your excitement to get it down there, you want to cross the line too soon.
For those of you that may not be totally familiar with the high school rules, they're pretty much the same as college.
First one on the kicking team, free kick.
You may have heard Andy Keel tell us that the penalty was against the Hilltoppers, so we'll re-kick it. But I just wanted to make, generally the rules are the same. The big difference is that there are only 12 minutes to each quarter for the various quarters during the ballgame. So we're about set to go. And we have the ball teed up once again. This one is a better kick, although it's aimed in the same general areas. Over that 18-yard line. That's picked up. This is Chris Ricks. And Ricks is out close to the 30-yard line.
Well, if they could have taken the other penalty, they would have had it at the 35.
All right, let's go down to the sidelines. Now Pimp Penn has an interview.
You, but not one that's the first for you. Tell us about your history with Hampton.
I've been going to the ball games since back in the 40s, and I think that the best ball player that I have seen is sitting right up here with Dick Carneal when we was there in the 48s. Now, I've seen a lots of them, but Porter's behind me back there. But I have enjoyed all of the games, and I just can't play it, but I love to be around it.
All right, great, thanks.
While we had that interview, we've had a fumble. Ronald Curry on the snap from center fumbled the football, and it was recovered by the Hilltoppers. So E.C. Glass gets a big break early in the ballgame on the first play from scrimmage.
Well, they really do, Tim. What happened was he slipped coming out of there, and he put his hand down, as you see, and as he went down, and I don't know that his knee wasn't down. He could have very well been called down, but they didn't do that.
All right, the Crabbers back on defense now. And the ball carrier initially for the Hilltoppers, that is number 20, Chris Matthews.
We'll get a chance.
Matthews struggles across the 20 down to about the 17.
Get a chance. We will show the offensive starters for Glass and the defensive starters for Hampton after this play. They will still line up in an I formation, and they'll split receivers both right and left. They like to run the isolation and the triple option. And here is the...
This is Kendrick, and he passed the ball tipped by Donnie Green. Goes incomplete as the pass was intended for number 45, Todd DeLemelure. But it was tipped by Green as he was coming down the near side trying to defend.
On defense for the Crabbers, Perry and Smith, the guards, Green and Monroe are the tackles. At defensive ends, we've got Baycoat and Groggins. The linebackers are White and Hollier. The defensive backs are Hawkins, McKenzie, and Ronald Curry is the safety.
And we'll give you the starting defense, offensive lineup, rather, for the Hilltoppers in just a moment. Third down and about four. In Hampton territory, Kendrick on the drop play. Gives to Matthews. Matthews to the 15, to the 14. Very close to a first down. And depending on where they mark his forward progress, I believe he has the first down.
It looks very good for the Hilltoppers.
And it is the first down. So the Hilltoppers got to the 13-yard line. Now for the DC Glass team, Speckman, Pennell, Randolph, Wolf, and Alexander are the interior linemen. The tight end is Younger, the split end is Banks. Hunter is the flanker for EC Glass. Give me the rest of that lineup in just a moment. First and 10 for EC Glass. This is Matthews, left side. He is down to the 10 to about the 9. There you see, DeLamalur is the fullback. Matthews, the young man who just carried the ball, is the tailback. And Andre Kendrick, number one, is the quarterback. So the Crabbers now facing a big stand here as the Hilltoppers are at the 9-yard line. They can get a first down without scoring. They have to get to the 3-yard line for the first down.
That's just a handoff from the straight eye formation.
Matthews gets to about the 6. It'll bring third down and about 3 for the Hilltoppers. I do not have statistics on their field goal kicker.
I don't either.
He is pretty much in range right now. As in most cases, this would be not much more than an extra point if the Crabbers could hold on this third down and bring up a 4. Third down and 3. Thacker is wide to the right. Hands off and a touchdown. This is Kendrick keeps the ball. Andre Kendrick scores from 6 yards.
Well, that was just no more than a quarterback keeper. It was open. He just took the thing, took a step back, and went right up the middle, untouched, for the initial score of the ball game.
So the Hilltoppers strike first after the Hampton turnover. Jeff Burke will be on to try the extra point. They consumed a little less than 3 minutes in bringing that 6 points to the board. Burke's kick is up. It is long enough, and it's good. Now there's a penalty flag down on the play.
See what the flag is.
Kendrick has scored for EC Glass at the 9-minute mark of the first quarter. Illegal procedure, and they'll make the Hilltoppers kick it again.
Well, that's well within range of this young man. I watched him warming up, and he was kicking the ball pretty well from the about around the 25 and the 30.
Of course, the range is not the biggest problem he's
illegal
faced with here.
Illegal formation by the offense. Point will be retried.
It was illegal formation is what he called.
So he'll try this extra point from the 15. So in fact, it will be the same as a 25-yard kick. His kick is up. It's plenty long. And it goes right through the uprights. So they have to do it twice, but the Hilltoppers get the extra point. And they have jumped out on top of the Hampton Crabbers by the score of 7-0. Contest was the very end of the touchdown. That was Kendrick who carried, and this young man is no foreigner to the end zone, as he has thrown for 20 touchdown passes. And if that's not enough, he's carried now 16 into the end zone himself.
We will pick a player of the game from the Hampton team today, and that player receive a plaque and a shirt. The plaque comes from Buckwalter and Gravy, located at Kickatan Road. Dave Buckwalter, owner. The shirt comes from the Islander Hardware and Sporting Goods, located in Pocosa. John Roberts, the owner.
Very uncharacteristic start for the Hampton. Not turn the ball over very often. Hilltoppers have made them pay with that turnover. All right, the kickoff
is coming to Avon Hawkins at the 7-yard line. Hawkins looking for a seam, gets a little bit of a break, gets the ball out across the 25 to about the 26-yard line. So that's where the Hampton Grabbers will start. It is not raining. The field is relatively dry, but it's very cold. And for that reason, I'm not making any excuses for the fumble, but it will be a difficult situation for both squads today.
Well, it'll make them play a little different. Now, Hampton should be a little used to this kind of a field. They were similar to this last week.
Curry this time rolling, looking. Wants to go, now has to, and it fumbles the ball again. The ball is loose, and it looks like it might be fumble recovery for EC Glass. And the official has yet to signal. I believe they're going to say Hampton recovered the fumble.
Looked like he was recovered by George Massenburg. 66 looked like he got on the ball.
Let me tell you, that was a huge recovery there. If EC Glass gets that ball, it's on the Hampton 13, and they would really put the Grabbers in a hole. So the second fumble in the first quarter for Ronald Curry. The young man, just a sophomore, maybe having a little bit of title game jitters, but I assure you this young man will play it back. All right, Curry, second and long, on the handoff. It goes to Chris Ricks, and Ricks gets out to about the 14-yard line.
Well, what you'll see is a 4-3 defense that the Hilltoppers will come in. They'll bring at least, they'll have seven men real close to the line of scrimmage, and sometimes they'll bring the strong safety up to lock on to the tight end. But most of the time, Hampton's going to look at a defense very similar to Denby. Denby runs a very similar defense to this.
Grabbers looking at third down and 22. The ball is marked just across the 13. Let's call it the 14-yard line. An obvious passing situation. Curry has good protection. Wants to go long. Throws it up. He's got up on Hawkins.
Tim, that was the same play that they ran before when Ron Curry got tackled and fumbled. Hawkins was open, but he didn't have time to find him that first time. But that time he did, wide open. Excellent throw and catch.
So from disaster to success, it looked for all the world that Hampton might have lost their second fumble in the first half of the first quarter. And a good recovery by the Crabbers. And again, the fumble recovery by Massenburg. And then the very next play, Ronald Curry burns the EC Glass Hilltoppers for 86 yards and an Avon Hawkins touchdown. Hey, we want to thank again Zoom Sitco for supporting our table cast all year long. They, along with the Hampton Chevrolet, here's your touchdown. He is throwing this ball from his 8-yard line. And we apologize for the crowd in front, but you can see the very end of it. That was Hawkins on the receiving end, and nobody was going to catch him once he caught the ball in the open field. Hawkins with great speed, and he made it look easy after the catch. Got a timeout called by the Hampton Grabbers, I believe.
Well, I don't know. The kick was made, and then it was waved off, so I'm not sure the reason. But we do want to thank Gear Up Printing for helping us sponsor these games. They've been sponsoring for us all year long, and we do appreciate Tom Gear. Steve Forbes and Mark Broadwell, attorneys of law, they
down there in Hampton, and they personal injuries are their what they specialize in. We appreciate them helping us all year long also.
And certainly last but not least, next to last but not least, Wood Funeral Home, where Richard Pulley is the funeral director, and Hampton Chevrolet. Again, we thank all of these five folks for helping us bring you the exciting football action on the peninsula. The Hampton Crabbers with, of course, their great season. The Kickitan Warriors with a super effort. Phoebus Phantoms, a team that should have been in the playoffs. And, of course, the Bethel Bruins, an up-and-coming team. And Coach Kozlowski will have those boys back in the hunt in the years to come. Crowd still buzzing here after the Hilltoppers had made it 7-0 after the Ronald Curry fumble, and then Ronald Curry made them pay dearly, and it's 7-all. The kick, a relatively short one, is fielded at the 10-yard line. Out
whoa!
To 24.
Tim, that was a hit down there. I didn't see who made it. Must have been 32. He was the last one up. I'm going to give it to him. That was Darrell Smith. That was
ball carrier four. The Hilltoppers was Cedric Johnson, number 25. So the Hilltoppers now with a lot worse field position than they enjoyed on their first possession will start from their 24-yard line. First down. Wide receiver to the near side is Marcus Banks, number 84. He is guarded by Amon Hawkins. Kendrick hands off up the middle. And a good gain out across the 30 to about the 32-yard line.
Well, Tim, one thing that you'll look, if you could go back and watch Hampton play about 3 or 4, maybe even 5 years ago, the offense that the Hilltoppers is running, very similar to what Hampton ran about 4 or 5 years ago.
Todd DeLamalure was the ball carrier, number 45.
They'll split two receivers and line up in an I formation. Sometimes they'll give you a trips to one side.
This time they're in the I formation, a handoff to Matthews. Matthews finds the hole plug, but he will get the first down as he reaches the 35-yard line. They needed to get across the 34, so that'll give a fresh set of downs to the Hilltoppers.
Well, Chris Matthews, Tim, has run the ball for 175 yard times coming in today and has had 26 touchdowns.
Actually, I think I've got a more updated statistic here.
Well, you may have. I got this from their coaches, and yeah. I may not have had last week's.
Well, this was from the Pulitzer Prize winning author.
Oh, well. I just threw mine away then.
Mike Keach, the main guy. The sports writing staff, of course, at the Daily Press. Mike Keach, Mike Holzblatt. And Al Pierce is here today. David Teal is here. They got all the guys.
And you got your buddy there, Bob.
Bob Moskovich.
Yeah,
Big Bob. It doesn't work at the Daily Press anymore, but he was a mainstay for years at the Daily Press. Bob Moskovich, fine gentleman, and we're glad to see him here along with many other folks. Almost a full house here at Todd Stadium. First down and 10 from the 35. This is Kendrick, and Kendrick on the option carries the ball for about 7 yards out to the 41-yard line.
Oh, he's a strong runner, Tim. I don't know how many yards that he's got this year, but he's run right well.
Almost 1,000 yards for Kendrick. I mean, he is so similar in many instances, not in appearance, but in the effectiveness that he has to Ronald Curry. Kendrick, of course, a senior at EC Glass, has carried 104 times for 923 yards, averages 8.8 yards per carry.
Well, most of the times he'll keep that was the option play, and that's what he did is he kept it on the option. And here we have his first pass.
And he will not get that pass away as he is set.
Monroe, along with our buddy Donnie Green, combined.
A huge loss all the way back to the 34-yard line. That is a 7-yard loss. And we got Biff Penn.
With the Hampton cheerleaders, I know you all are really excited for those who are coming on a first championship. What do you have to say to your team? First of all, what's your name?
Lorraine Spencer.
Okay, and you're the captain?
Co-captain.
Okay.
I'm Kimberly Saunders, the other co-captain.
Okay, what do you girls want to say to everybody out there in Crabbley?
We're glad we're here. Let's go, Big Red!
Yeah! A great sprint draw that time, Tim.
Back to the play on the field. Chris Matthews all the way out across midfield to the Hampton 49-yard line. Chris Matthews is eating up yardage up the middle there, and he has the ball in Hampton territory. This is such a potent offensive team. This Matthews, 1,501 yards, averages almost 8 yards every time he touches the ball. And coming into this game, had 27 touchdowns. Kendrick gives to the big fullback. This is Delamalur, and Delamalur gets maybe a yard or two at the most.
Well, he ran into big Marcus Smith, 5'11", 267, and he didn't get much.
Derek White in on the stop as well for the Grabbers, so a short gain, maybe a yard.
But what the Hilltoppers would like to do is establish that run game and then burn you with a pass when you get everybody up tight.
Wide receivers to the near side. There's two of them out down on this side and one to the left. The handoff, however, goes to Matthews. And Matthews, good yardage, has another first down at the Hampton 38-yard line. So Matthews with success up the middle and a good offensive line blocking by the Hilltoppers.
They're doing a great job opening some holes in there. I'm sure that Crabbers are going to make some adjustments, but you want to try to make some adjustments on the field at the same time.
You know, looking back in the history of these squads, of course, Mike Smith, the head coach at Hampton, in his 25 years there, has 256 wins, 41 defeats, and two ties. Bo Henson, on the other side, 18 years, 147 wins, only 56 losses and six ties. 70% for Henson, 85% winning percentage for Mike Smith at Hampton. These squads go all the way back to 1899 when Hampton started, in 1902 for EC Glass. And 604 victories, of course, for the Hampton team, 570 for EC Glass. I want to thank our friends at the Daily Press for giving me all these wonderful statistics. Kendrick feels some pressure, gets away from one man, gets away from another man. He is so elusive, and he finally gets away from a third man down the sideline and pushed out of bounds, but not before he gets very close to another first down.
He is very elusive, and he's hard to bring down. He's got quick feet. He's stocky. He's only about, they got him listed about 5'8"?
5'8", but he's listed in the program as 5'10", but I understand he's close to 5'8". We got a player down, that's Mark Baycoat for the Hampton Crabbers down at the Hampton 30-yard line. Here's the replay. You're going to see Kendrick. This play starts out to the right. Then he gets away from one would-be tackler, yet another one. He is so, as you said, real quick feet, missed by Baycoat, and I think Baycoat was hurt on the play.
Well, he's had a problem with his shoulder, and he reaching for him that time may be what happened.
Mark Baycoat is coming off the field, and he is favoring his right arm, I guess, or he's kind of gingerly moving his left arm, so I'm not really sure which.
I'm not sure which one either, but I would assume it would be the left one, yep. The way he's trying to rotate it, trying to get some movement out of it. That'll bring in Crawford will play that defensive end, or somebody on that side. Let's see who they put over there.
Gain of about 8 on the last play. This brings up a second down and a short 2. And now the EC Glass team, well, I started to say they're going to go. Let's go back down to the sideline.
Busy lady over in Crabberland. Tell us some of your activities.
Well, I'm a teacher at Hampton High School. I work with the senior class sponsor. And I'm also chairman of the 100 celebration in Hampton, 100 years of Crabber Pride. So
and today is no different, no doubt.
Yes. We are excited. And we know that the students are excited. And all the Hampton fans are here. And they are excited, too, about Hampton High School's football team.
Who's gonna win?
Hampton, of course. Yes, go big red.
I believe it's Kenny Crawford who came up with the ball, Tim.
All right, back to the field of play. Kenny Crawford has recovered the fumble, so EC Glass now has committed a crucial turnover. This, of course, not quite as bad as the one Hampton had deep in their own end of the field, but nonetheless.
Here we watch the replay, Tim.
Yeah, let's see what happened here. This is Matthews, and the ball appeared to be stripped by Monroe and then very alertly grabbed and covered by Crawford. So the Crabbers on offense from their 20. This is about Hawkins, and Hawkins running the ball for the first time in several weeks now. Hawkins ran the ball back when Chris Ricks got hurt in the middle of the season, had a huge two-game effort of better than 400 yards, and he carries the ball. And this, I would assure you, Bo Henson has not seen this formation with Von Hawkins running the ball.
No, they really haven't, Tim, but the field is a slow field. As you see, it's hard to make your cuts and moves, even though Hawkins got through there. He didn't pick up the yardage that the coaching staff thought he could.
Pick up a four on the play, on the pitch. This is Hawkins. He gets a good seal block on the right end. Hawkins gets by one man. He's down the sideline. He is driven out of bounds at midfield. Ahmad Hawkins all the way out to the Hampton 49-yard line.
Well, you see what Hampton's trying to do. They've got some speed in Hawkins, and they know they can get outside on that triple option. And if they don't pick up the pitch man, Curry will keep it. They pitched it. Hawkins picked up, I don't know how many yards that was. 24 yards, as Bob Killen, our statistician here, tells us.
All the way out to the 49-yard line. Grabber's taking an inordinate amount of time to get this play off now. We don't have a huddle clock to observe. Hawkins comes out of the game. Chris Ricks is in there. The swing pass is to Chris Ricks. He is wide open. Good block downfield, and Ricks all the way down to the 38-yard line for another Hampton first down.
I'll tell you how bad the field is if referees are falling.
Let's go back to the sideline. I know you've seen many championships, but today is really exciting. What are your thoughts? Hampton going to win. Hampton's going to win. Okay. Do you have any favorite player or just the entire team?
Just the entire team.
Okay, good. Thanks for talking with us. Thanks.
All right. At the 38-yard line, the Hampton Grabbers first and 10. 7-7 is our score. A minute 13 remaining here in the first quarter. Division 5 title game. This is for all the marbles. This is White, and Derek White will maybe get a yard at very most.
Well, that's that little quick trap that Hampton runs and very successful at. The first time I've seen him do that with a man in motion. They're giving just a couple of different looks, kind of confusing, trying to confuse the Hilltoppers defense a little bit.
I'll throw that tackle for the Hilltoppers.
Second down and 9 for Hampton. We're inside of 35 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Ronald Curry on play action, and we have a flag down.
I don't know what the flag before the ball was snapped or what it was. Tim, Curry has passed 2 times for 99 yards.
Of course, one of those was 86.
Well, that's quite an average, though, wouldn't you say?
Yes. The illegal procedure penalty will be marked off against the Hampton Crabbers. It'll move the ball out to the Hilltoppers 43.
We have a snap infraction on the offense. 5 yards, replay the down.
What actually happened was the ball never got snapped from center. It looked like a play action fake. It was real good play action fake because the quarterback never even got the snap.
Well, it faked me out. I thought Curry had the ball.
They mark the ball now at EC Glass's 43-yard line. Second down and 15 for the Crabbers. Actually, second down and about 14. Over the middle, the pass for Blizzard through his hands and almost picked up by Crawford further downfield. But Blizzard was the intended receiver. He was guarded on the play by number 3, Telly Tucker of EC Glass. There you see coming back to the huddle is Kenny Crawford.
Well, I don't think the coaches didn't see that. He was open. The primary receiver on that, of course, was Blizzard. They're trying to pick up the first down, and they need about 14, as you said.
You saw on the replay as Curry rifled that ball through the hands of Bobby Blizzard.
Well, only using a 4-man rush.
And Curry goes down, and of course, in high school ball, once your knee hits the ground, you cannot get back up. Now, the crowd booing, they don't think Curry actually had his knee touch the ground, and to be honest with you, from up here, it looked like it did.
Well, there's no way we're going to see that from up here, but that is the end of the first quarter, Tim.
So the surface playing condition here at Todd Stadium has been a bit of a factor, although, again, considering this is late in the season, I mean, we're into December, and it's amazing that the field is in as good a shape as it is. All right, let's go down to the sideline of the Hampton cheerleaders.
The Hampton Crabbers and the UACS together for the winning team.
For our Channel 5 coverage as we get set to start the second quarter. The Hampton Crabbers will be looking at a fourth down and about 21 to go, and an obvious punting condition or position. But, you know, last week on a much worse field than this, Ronald Curry tried a fake, but unfortunately the footing was so bad that he was never able to get on track with that one.
You're right. I remember that very well. He made his move, and as he tried to cut, feet went right out from under him. And one time before, earlier in the first quarter, when he was punting, his feet slipped right out from under him. So we'll see what happens on this. I want to thank Islander Hardware and Sporting Good and Buckwalter Engraving for their help in helping us all year long recognize a player of the game from all the Hampton schools. We've done it all year. They do it for us in basketball and baseball and softball when we do those contests, and we do appreciate it, and we thank them again.
During the transition at the end of the quarter there, Mike Smith, the head coach for Hampton, was talking with referee Neal and undoubtedly pleading his case, if not for that call, at least setting up a favorable position later on. Mike Smith may have felt that Ronald Curry's knee did not touch the ground. That ball will go into the end zone, and it'll be an automatic touchback, and the EC Glass Hilltoppers will have the ball at the 20. With our score 7-7, just underway here in the second quarter. Tim Cole, along with Bob Hintz and our Channel 5 crew, the A-team, all here today for this one. Wouldn't miss it.
We got them all. We got Robert Killen over here, Big Bobby Killen, doing our stats for us and keeping us up to state. We really got kind of spoiled last week. I know you did. let me talk about the head coach, the coaches over for the EC Glass, as soon as we get done with this play. I do want to recognize the coaches.
All right, the Hilltoppers, first and 10 from the 20. This is Chris Matthews, and he has tripped up after a couple of yards, after about the 22.
Head coach is Bo Henson. He's assisted by Mike Berry, Dickie Bird, Tony Carden, Ry Coleman, Ed Dillinger, Tom Holden, Glenn Jenkins, Bobby Johnson, Jerome Johnson, and Dennis Peters.
What you just saw there was a replay of when Curry's knee supposedly hit the ground. Now, we, again, from that shot, couldn't tell. And heavens knows the official was right there to see it. But it was a controversial play in the sense that it looked like he may have prevented his knee from hitting by putting his hand down, but the official ruled that he was down by contact. All right, the second play in a row, the Crabbers' defense has stiffened against this running attack of the Hilltoppers. They were having some difficulty in the first quarter stopping this run.
And they've made a couple of adjustments in there, and I'm not that good of a technician to tell you what adjustments they are, but the holes that they were running in that were open before are not opening this time, and maybe it's because they're stopping that big fullback from making that initial block. He's not getting that initial block.
Third down and about 7 for the Hilltoppers.
We may see a pass.
Kendrick, who can pass with the best of them, has plenty of time. Now he gets a little bit of pressure, but he gets away from a tackler. And then he is taken down at the 25-yard line, initially hit by Crawford. And then finally Monroe finished him off, and that'll bring up a punt formation for the Hilltoppers. You made mention of the Hilltoppers coaches. Of course, the head coach at Hampton, Mike Smith. He is assisted by Alvis Mann, Danny Mitchell, Lanny Franklin, Todd Summers, Kenny Gilliam, Shannon Smith, Kevin Carter, Michael Carter, and Adolph Hawkins. And, of course, the athletic director, trainer, not athletic, the athletic
you almost
trainer
did it again.
Is Diane Limerick. The athletic director is Trich Mitchell.
Oh, man.
High snap from the center, a good snap ultimately, but it's fielded at the 49-yard line by Ronald Curry. So the Crabbers get the ball back exactly where they had punted from a few moments ago.
And that's great field position for them. They've got a new set of downs, and they're going from where they kicked before. We do want to tell you that we want to thank the Lifeline, who has a special for anybody who watches this broadcast. They can go down and get a special membership. It's for a limited time only, but we appreciate them helping us with the sponsorship all year long. And, of course, Tom Gear and Gear Up Printing, again, have helped us all year long.
This is Chris Rex. Rex into the open, to the 40, to the 35, a first down, 15 yards. Stop on the play was made by number two, Garnett McDaniel, but Chris Rex, who had better than 1,300 yards on the regular season and the postseason.
Tim, I'm not too sure of that spot. He lowered his head, and he really ran into a player, and I thought he went on the other side of the 35.
It did look like he got to the 35. Here's the replay. You're going to see good blocking on the right side. And Chris,
now watch
Rex,
this. Nope,
that was good.
Well, good spot.
Good spot. 35 and a half yard line. Curry wanted to keep on the quarterback keeper, and EC Glass had that one spelled out big time as he never even got started.
Well, what happened was the two guards pinched in, or the two tackles, really. They run two tackles, two defensive ends, and three linebackers, and they pinched in, and they were ready for that play.
That was Carl Bradley, number 77, who was ready and waiting, and Curry lost about a half a yard on the play. It brings up second down, let's call it 10. 8:55 remaining in the first half, and we're tied at 7-all. Ronald Curry has Crawford to the near side, Hawkins wide to the left. The pitch goes to Chris Rex. Rex trying to turn the corner, gets away from one tackler, finally taken down at the 30-yard line. He'll be short of the first down by about 3 or 4 yards. So it'll bring up a third down and about 4 for the Grabbers.
Well, that was a great run by Rex trying to get around the corner. He did get around the corner. You know, you look at it, you say, well, he could cut in. But, Tim, us saying cut in and down there on that field cutting in is two different things. He had good power and good speed. He is a sprinter.
Cedric Johnson did a good job from his defensive corner position to make the stop. We've got motion on the EC Glass side of the field.
What do you know? Do you think that's what the play we think it is?
If they were not pulled off, that'll be enough for a first down. Let's see how they call this one. And it's encroachment, so that'll give the Crabbers enough for the first down, basically by the length of the football.
Dead ball. Encroachment by the defense. First down.
Well, we've seen Mike Smith do that. The coaches in the peninsula are ready for that. They're geared up. In fact, few of them use it. Kurt Newsom is one that comes to mind. But teams from the other side, other areas, they're not used to it.
25-yard line, first down. Curry with plenty of time. Got a man wide open at the 10. Touchdown! Kenny Crawford at the goal line.
What a beautiful pattern run by Crawford, and put the ball right on the money. Ronald Curry, that's why, you know, they say that this other young man is the best quarterback in Virginia. I've got to question their thought processes. I don't think that they have seen this young man, people up in Northwestern Virginia.
Ronald Curry right on the money, a 25-yard pass and catch to Kenny Crawford. Shepherd will try the extra point, a high snap. They're going to have to run for it now. Crawford trying to turn the left end. He's going to go for two, but he will not get in. Now, that ball is a loose ball. And they say, no, they cannot be advanced. Now, in some situations, and maybe it's college I'm thinking of, if you muff a two-point conversion, the other team can take it and run down the field.
Well, the only reason that was a two-point conversion, that was a very high snap from center. That was the only thing that Crawford could have done, too. Look at that catch. Was that a beautiful, I mean, went up in the air, concentrated on getting that ball in his hands, knowing he was going to get hit, Tim.
And he got hit. Number two for the EC Glass Hilltoppers, McDaniel, nailed him, and to Crawford's credit, absolutely, he held up. Crawford, that is his fourth touchdown of the season. And coming into the game, Crawford had a total of 10 catches for 243 yards.
We tried to give him a touchdown against Deep Creek.
I tried my best.
Kenny
Jackson.
Kenny Jackson.
Yeah, and we apologized, I did, for that error last week, and I want to reiterate that against Deep Creek.
Tim, I want to make a correction, too. Last week we said that Hollier caused the fumble from the big tight end. As we watched the
this is the touchdown
pass, it was McKenzie who made the hit. And I apologize to McKenzie because that was a real pivotal move on the Hampton stop because they stopped the drive of the
line,
team.
Line drive kickoff taken at the 12-yard line and returned out to about the 27 where the Hilltoppers will have it first and 10. But the Crabbers, after giving up a fumble on the first play from scrimmage, have made it 13-7 now. Curry, by the way, 3 out of 4 for 124 yards and 2 touchdowns here in the first half.
And we're not even halfway through the second quarter.
Ronald Curry, who has just been phenomenal both of his seasons, and that's right, if you're new to this game, Curry is just a sophomore. And if when the football season is over with, come on down and watch him play basketball. He's touted as one of the best basketball players in the state, if not the country. But that's another story we'll get to later on. This is Kendrick on the option, and Kendrick will get nowhere.
Well, I tell you, Hampton has worked on that option all week long. They want to stop that option because they know that's one of their bread and butter plays, that and their ISO play, which is just a dive to the tailback. Great job by Green that time.
Donnie Green, a player of the game a couple of games ago, and he has just really risen to the top of his game, and he has led the Hampton defense to this game. Gain of a half a yard, let's call it second down and 10. Kendrick straight back to pass, now rolling along the line of scrimmage and looking for an option, and he will not get back much more than a yard.
There is just, that was almost a coverage sack. Nobody was open, nobody he could throw the ball to, and the defense kept pushing pressure on him and pressure on him, and there was nowhere for him to go.
But you've got Hawkins, McKenzie, and Curry in the deep back for the Crabbers. You just have three fast defenders that you can have on the field.
Well, it's good to see Mark Baco back in there, number 15. That was not a serious injury. He's playing the linebacker on this side or the defensive end on this side.
Play action fake. Kendrick wants to throw long. He's got a man deep. And the ball is picked off. This is McKenzie at the 40 and Collard at the 30, rather the 45-yard line, but it'll be half the ball.
It's funny that when another quarterback throws the ball up, our three backs, whether it's Curry, McKenzie, or Hawkins, they assume that they're the receiver because they end up with the ball. Great job. He didn't worry about the man. He went to the ball.
And it's a good thing. The ball was underthrown, and again, we can't emphasize the win factor. Here's the replay. A.T. Hunter was the intended receiver on the play. Kendrick got plenty of time to throw the ball, and he threw it up, and the ball just kind of hung in the air, and Kadafi McKenzie came down with the INT. Back to the live action. This is Chris Ricks. Ricks across the 59 to the 47.
And he'd have gone a lot further if it hadn't been for number 45, and I have trouble with his name, but he got a jersey. If he hadn't got that jersey, Ricks would have picked up at least 5 more yards.
Todd DeLamalure, whose father
DeLamalure. Well, I might get it before the end of the game.
He was a pro player. A nice article about this young man in the Daily Press, I believe it was Thursday, about DeLamalure. But his daddy before him, and this DeLamalure plays both sides of the ball and plays a great game. Pickup of 8 on the last, and this is Chris Ricks. The ball comes loose, but I believe they'll say he was down by contact. The Hilltoppers can run all the way to the parking lot, but it will not count.
He was most certainly down.
Short of the first down as they brought him down at about the 46 and a half yard line of EC Glass, just inside the 47. The Crabbers need to get to the 45 for a first. But the down by contact, the ball came loose, but it was after the play was blown dead. 5:12, the clock moving here in the first half as the Crabbers holding on to a 13-7 lead in a quest for their 13th state title in their 96-year history. Now Ronald Curry looks over the defense and sees something he's not sure he likes.
No, what happened was he was trying to draw them offside because they did jump a little, but they didn't come across in the neutral zone. So he called a timeout, going to talk with the coaches.
Well, again, we want to thank the folks over at Hampton Chevrolet. Here's the fumble, by the way, or the actually not a fumble, the non-fumble, if you will. see if we can pick up. But again, we want to thank the folks at Hampton Chevrolet for their support, as well as the folks with David Allen and Zoom's Sitco. And here's the replay of the play that the Crabbers had, where Chris Ricks, boom, he is down by contact. The ball popped up in the air, and EC Glass, Raven Vereen, thought he had a fumble recovery, but it was a dead ball. But at any rate, we've been thanking individually our sponsors, but we want to collectively thank all of the five businesses that have helped support our bringing you the Cablecast here on Channel 5. If you, as a business, would be interested in helping us bring sporting events to the public, we have basketball all lined up to go, and it's going to be a great season on the peninsula once again. So if you'd like to find out how you can support our coverage, very effectively at a very inexpensive cost.
Yeah, I thought it was pretty effective.
That's right. Third down and two for the Crabbers. And ahead of a fumble. This ball is a live ball. And Ronald Curry will save a touchdown. But the ball recovered by Robert Spencer, number 14, from EC Glass. And they have the ball at the Hampton 28-yard line.
A big turnover.
That's the second turnover by the Crabbers that has given EC Glass excellent field position. The first turnover led to the Hilltoppers touchdown. So turnovers starting to be a factor in this game for the Crabbers. Now both squads have at least two timeouts remaining. The scoreboard here does not list the number of timeouts. I know Hampton's called one. Now EC Glass, in fact, is going to take another timeout. So he will take the timeout, and that'll come with 4:38 left here in the first half. Get a chance to watch this again. You're going to see right here the ball stripped and picked up, and Ronald Curry with the presence of mind to immediately go to the ball and prevent what would have been a sure touchdown. So the Crabbers have had a little bit of fumble-itis, and this is not typical of that team.
No, it really isn't, but that's... It makes you, the coaching staff, you know, they expect there's going to be some adversity into a ball game, but it's how you react to that adversity that makes the difference.
On the season, the Crabbers have only turned the ball over a total of 12 times. 12 times in 13 games, so they average less than one turnover per game.
Well, they're above their average now, so they want to stop.
Kendrick comes
from the shotgun.
Shotgun,
you're right.
Throws and picked off. Ronald Curry in your face. Curry down the sideline. Still inbound. Picks up a block. Still on his feet all the way to the 45-yard line. And a late flag, a stupid play by number 57 of EC Glass. He shoved Curry after the play was over.
But he was pushed into Curry to give him, you know, his due also. But it may have been his old man that pushed him, so.
It wasn't a flagrant foul, but he did push Curry, and that will tack on 15 additional yards to the play. That'll give Hampton the ball at the EC Glass 30. Talk about a turn of events.
I tell you, that's one thing that you can say about Hampton is they can face adversity and then come up with spectacular results.
Here is the replay.
After the run ended, personal foul on the White.
Pick it up.
First down.
No. We'll see it from that shot. In any event, Ronald Curry with the INT returns the ball to the 35, and now they'll 45 rather, and now they'll tack on the 15. And they'll give the ball to Hampton at the EC Glass 30. So in a matter of
back-to-back
moments,
turnovers.
Moments, instead of first and 10 at the Hampton 38, now it's first and 10 at the EC Glass 30. And still plenty of time remaining, 4:10. It only takes Curry one pass. Now we have an official's stoppage of play.
Yeah, we have an equipment problem, it looks like. Now we're ready to go.
Kendrick this afternoon, by the way, the quarterback for EC Glass, has not completed a pass to a blue and white player, but he has thrown two to the Crabbers.
I'm impressed with that big number 77, Tim, playing for the Glass team. That's Carl Bradley, 6'4", 271. Tough.
All right, we're going to return to Todd Stadium for the conclusion of the first half after this brief timeout. Second down and about nine. This is Chris Ricks, and Ricks, check
no,
that, not Ricks, but in fact it's number 32.
Darryl Smith.
Darryl Smith coming out of the backfield, and Smith down to about the 22-yard line. It'll be shy of the first down by about 2 yards. So a little less than 3 minutes to go. The Crabbers with third down and two. Ball is at the EC Glass 23-yard line. This will be coming right at you. There you'll see the effort, a superb effort by Darryl Smith.
I mean, he was hit and still turned and twisted and picked up a couple more yards.
Third down and a pair. Play actions. Curry rolling, looking in the end zone. He goes shorter to Blizzard. Blizzard at the 5-yard line. First and goal for the Crabbers.
What a nice play. I mean, Ron Curry runs to his left, squares his shoulders, and hits the receiver on the run as well as any quarterback I've seen. I don't care if you go college or pro, he does that as well as any of them.
Bobby Blizzard coming into this game with 20 catches for 416 yards, three touchdowns coming into the game. That one was a first and goal at the EC Glass 3-yard line. Crabbers leading 13-7, 2 minutes and 14 seconds remaining in the half.
A little over 20 yards on that play, about 20 yards on that play.
Yep. This is Smith, and he will not get in the end zone. In fact, he gets to about the line of scrimmage, and that's about all.
Well, I thought he got maybe down to the one or two.
Looked like someone might have grabbed the face mask, but no penalty flag coming down. So pickup of maybe a yard. It's marked at the 2-yard line now. Second down and goal. Here's the replay. Just a straight handoff to Darryl Smith. And through no lack of effort on his part, he was held to a short gain. Now we have movement on the defensive side. We'll see if EC Glass was pulled off or jumped off. It's an encroachment penalty against EC Glass, so that'll be half the distance. They'll put it at the 1-yard line.
Before the snap, encroachment by the defense, half the distance to the goal, second down.
So you heard Andy Keel tell you the penalty, and the Crabbers now with second and goal at the 1. Ronald Curry over center, and he just gives to Smith, and Smith is in for the score.
That was a great job of blocking by that offensive line, and we don't give them credit like we ought to. Adam Lively, Groggins, and Massenberg at guards, Green and Smith, Marcus Smith at tackles. Just opened up a beautiful hole, Tim.
So the Crabbers have gone on top now 19-7, and they'll undoubtedly go for two here. Crabbers with the touchdown after the turnover, paying back, if you will, EC Glass for doing that to them on the first series from in the first quarter. Crabbers send Hawkins to the near side and Crawford to the left out of an I formation. And now Curry will probably burn the last timeout the Crabbers had. And again, I don't think he was trying to pull him off. He may have been.
Yo, he really was, Tim, because then you figure you got 1.5 yards rather, as you see the touchdown, you got 1.5 yards rather than 3 yards. So it's easier for a running play to get in, and it gives you more options.
Oh, sure.
So, yeah, I believe that was exactly what the call was they were trying to do that time.
So the clock stopped with 1:25 remaining in the first half. The EC Glass Hilltoppers scored first. If you joined us late, the Crabbers turned it over on the first play from scrimmage. And Kendrick, the quarterback for the Hilltoppers, scored from 6 yards out, and they kicked the extra point to lead 7-0 and quiet the Hampton crowd, at least temporarily.
That was maybe 4 minutes.
Yeah, because right after that, the Crabbers with a third and 22.
Well, when was it? When was the big score? What time was it?
It was about 4 minutes later.
Okay.
The gentleman you see there, the next candidate for the President of the United States, Pulitzer Prize and Nobel Prize winner Mike Keats. I've been joking.
He heard you because he turned and looked at you. He says, "You got it right, but I'm not going to smile."
I'm kidding, obviously. He doesn't have all those awards, but he is a candidate for a present.
But Mike Keach does a great job along with all the other writers of the Daily Press. And Al Pierce, David Teal is here today, Mike Holzklaw. We appreciate all of their help in providing us with statistics throughout the year. It's truly enhanced our coverage. Ahmad Hawkins, 2 points. He gets in the end zone, and it is a 21-7 score.
And he dove in. He knew he was going to get hit, but it didn't make any difference because his momentum carried him in. 21 straight points by the Crabbers.
Let's give some updates on the touchdowns. Now, when and we'll watch this replay again, as you do. This is Hawkins. Watch him dive into the end zone, and the ball came loose, but it had broken the plane in his possession. But into this game, Hawkins had a total of 15 touchdowns, and he had 2 two-point conversions. Now he has 3, and he has, of course, 16 touchdowns now. Kenny Crawford, coming in, had 4 touchdowns, and he's added 1 to his statistics. And, of course, Mr. Smith, Darryl Smith, his touchdown was the 6th of the season for the Hampton Crabbers. So after spotting EC Glass, a 7-0 lead, the Crabbers have roared back with 3 touchdowns.
Well, I tell you, nothing will hurt you any more than to go in at halftime, being on a high, scoring first, getting at 7 points, and then giving up 21 straight points. You've got to have a quarterback who has been known to throw the ball and who has not been able to throw the ball effectively.
EC Glass out to the 24-yard line, a ball carrier. Number 25, Cedric Johnson, picked it up at the 5 and returned it to the 25, a 20-yard return.
And there are our young man that we talk about quite often, Donnie Green, number 75, made the initial hit.
So EC Glass will have a minute and 16. The clock is moving.
Well, they get the ball to start the second half, Tim, so they may not do anything stupid here. If they throw it up, Hampton can score with a minute to go.
EC Glass spreads it out big time. 2 double wide receivers to each side. Kendrick from the shotgun loops a pass to Chris Matthews, and Matthews goes out of bounds at the 30.
That'll
stop the clock with 55 seconds remaining. There you see the scoreboard here at John B. Todd Stadium in Newport News. Tim Cole along with Bob Hitz.
What Kendrick had to do that time, Tim, was almost like a little basketball, and he is a real good basketball player, they tell me, that he would like to play college football and basketball, but he just kind of dumped the ball over the linebacker that was in that flat area.
Pickup of about 5 on the play. Second down, let's call it 4, as it was almost a 6-yard gain. Kendrick, with lots of time, throws right to Mark Baycote. Mark Baycote will race for the end zone. He has Kendrick to beat. Baycote will not get in, but he'll be down at the 3-yard line, first and goal.
Well, Hampton has no timeouts, but I can't believe, you know, I'm looking over this at the end of the team. Why would you want to do that? Go in at halftime, regroup, make your adjustments, and come out. Now you give Hampton a chance to go up by 3 touchdowns.
Well, on top of that, if we have it on replay, Baycote was the only man 10 yards to the ball.
Well, that's a good point, too.
Here's the replay. I mean, this was a terrible pass by Kendrick. But watch this. He's going to throw it in the area. Baycote's the only man there. And Kendrick saved the touchdown. Now, Ronald Curry will simply down the ball to stop the clock. As you said, Bob, the timeouts are all used up by the Crabbers. So with 35 seconds remaining, the Crabbers will have a second and goal at the 4-yard line. So they have plenty of time to get the 3 downs. Of course, I'm a bit surprised, to be quite honest with you, that they didn't have some kind of play on. If nothing else, a quick look into the end zone, and if it's not there, you throw it away. But the Crabbers did not want to take that chance. They obviously didn't have much of an opportunity to get their offensive team in sync after the quick turnover and Mark Baycote's interception, the 3rd turnover of the first half. This is Curry, play action, throwing in the end zone and stumbling and unable to make the catch was Darryl Smith as he lost his footing right about the goal line.
He was open and so was Bobby Blizzard open. And Bobby is saying, here I am.
So 4 seconds winds off the clock as Sonny Dirth, I guess every sports writer at the Daily Press is here today.
They're all here.
And even Bob Moskowitz.
Well, they're checking on you to see if you really do what you say you do.
Third and goal. Curry rolling, looking, gets away from one man, but not another as he is sacked. And that may prevent the Crabbers from getting another playoff. They're going to have to hurry. I think they'll have time, but it is fourth and goal. So the Hilltoppers defense has risen to the occasion. Crabbers will get one last play away here in the first half. Curry, play action fake. Throws, lofts it up in the end zone. Batted down, incomplete as time expires here in the first half.
Well, Curry was falling forward and was being hit that time as he let go. That was not a good pass and not a typical Ron Curry pass.
The Crabbers with an excellent opportunity to add to their 21-7 lead with a first and goal at the 4-yard line. But to the Hilltoppers' defense, their defense did the job to keep Hampton from building a bigger lead as we have come to halftime. Our score at halftime in the Group AAA Division 5 State Championship game, the Hampton Crabbers 21, the EC Glass Hilltoppers 7. We'll return to Todd Stadium for the third quarter of action after this brief timeout. We'll be right back.
You're watching WHCS Cable Channel 5, educational television for our community of learners.
Halftime, the score 21-7 in favor of the Hampton Crabbers. The Easy Glass Hilltoppers scored first. Kendrick from 6 yards out. The extra point was good. That came after a Ronald Curry fumble on the first play from scrimmage for the Hampton Crabbers. Well, the Crabbers, with a third down and 22, had Amon Hawkins receive an 86-yard pass from Ronald Curry to make it 7-all, and then ever since then, it's been all Hampton. Crawford on the 25-yard pass reception, and then Smith with the final score in the first half from 1 yard out. And Amon Hawkins scored a two-point conversion to make it 21-7. You see the team captains meeting at the center of the field. And we're set to go down to the sideline.
I'm with Joe Hawkins, Director of Transportation. Joe, it's been a real interesting first half. What are your thoughts on the first half, and what's going to happen in the second half?
Well, I think in the first half, it was nip and tuck. Either team could have scored more times because it had a lot to do with fumbles and the recovery of fumbles. In the second half, if EC Glass can gain the momentum in the beginning of the game, I think they'll make a game out of it. However, if they don't, then Hampton will win it.
So the locker room talk has a whole lot to do with what's going to happen now, huh?
If EC Glass has made the necessary adjustments and can come back, then it could be a different ball game. Short of that, it'll be a Hampton victory.
And that's what we're looking for.
That's correct.
Absolutely.
All right, we have halftime statistics for you, I believe. And we'll show those to you as we are set to get the second half underway.
Is that Hollier doing the kicking off?
Darnell Hollier will kick exactly, and he will kick to either Kendrick, number one, or to Cedric Johnson, number 25 of EC Glass. Actually, it's a short kick, and the ball goes out of bounds at about the 38-yard line. So the Hilltoppers will have the option of having Hampton kick it over, or they could take it at that point, and undoubtedly they will. Here are the halftime statistics. First downs, Crabbers 6-4. Carries 18 carries for 66 yards for Hampton, 18 for 80 yards for the Hilltoppers. Passing, the Crabbers 4 out of 7, no interceptions. 5 passes, 1 completion, 2 interceptions.
Illegal procedure on the kicking team. Receiving team will take the ball at the 37, first down.
144 yards passing, just 6 yards for the Hilltoppers. And there you see the total offense, 210 to 86 yards. Hampton penalized once for 5 for 31 for the Hilltoppers. And 3 fumbles with 2 lost fumbles for the Crabbers and 1-1 for the Hilltoppers. But the Hilltoppers' pass interceptions have been the big story here in the ballgame.
It really has. They come back out in their the basic set offensively that they were in at the beginning of the game. Towards the end of the game, remember they went into that shotgun formation. They got their quarterback, Kendrick, underneath the center, running from the eye, and the 2 split men.
Gain of a little more than 5 on the first down. Second down, and let's call it 5. Kendrick gives to Matthews. Matthews is struggling close to a first down. They need to get to the EC Glass 47, and they'll mark it just short of that. It'll be third down. This is the battle for the Division 5 state championship. Ironically, the last time that each of these teams won a state championship was during the same year. Hampton won here at Todd Stadium in a game that the weather was not dissimilar to this. In fact, there was snow on the field that day.
Well, that was against Salem, I believe, if I remember correctly.
Robinson.
Robinson.
On
third and a yard is going to be very close. It depends on where they mark the ball. Chris Matthews was the ball carrier for EC Glass, and it looks like he may have gotten it, but it depends on the mark.
Well, I would venture to say he's half a football short, so I'm going out on a limb here if looking at the spot.
Now, EC Glass, the year I'm speaking of course, was 1988, and it was here at Todd Stadium that Hampton beat Robinson for the title. And EC Glass, same year, different division.
Well, I was wrong. It was a half of football the other way.
All right, so the first down is, in fact, the case for the Hilltoppers. Got a good mark. Of course, this is the 13th state championship quest for the Crabbers. They've got 12, while EC Glass has 3. Kendrick in a world of trouble. He is sacked all the way back to the 38-yard line.
Well, he lost that ball coming out from center. I don't know if it looked like there was a pass play called. There were 3 receivers downfield, and he was going to roll to his left. Tim, he just never got a good exchange, or he never held on to the ball. Crabbers did a great job. I think it was Crawford that finally collared him.
So the big loss on the play for EC Glass, 10 yards on the play. It's second down and 20 for the Hilltoppers. Kendrick over center at the 38-yard line, rolling to his right, looking downfield. Throws, it's a short pass, and it's extremely short in that it one hops to the intended receiver, Hunter Thacker, the wide receiver, the 6-foot senior from EC Glass. So the pass attack, which has been most prolific all year for the Hilltoppers, has failed them this afternoon. Coming into this game, Kendrick better than 60% completions for better than 1,600 yards and 20 catches, but so far he has thrown more to the red and black of Hampton than he has to the blue and white.
And he just doesn't look as smooth throwing the ball as Ronald Curry does. He may be pressing a little bit.
And he hadn't probably faced a defense quite as good as this one all year either. Gets some pressure, rolling, gets away from one man, still on his feet, across the 45, out to midfield. It'll be a fourth down. Gets to the Hampton 48-yard line, but the first down marker is the 42. So it'll be fourth down at about 6 for the Hilltoppers. Kendrick will come off the field, and I believe we'll see the punting team on for EC Glass.
And who is that back to punt, Tim? I can't get his number.
I believe 88, that's 88. That's Harrington. Fourth down and 6. Ronald Curry back deep for the Crabbers. Gets it away. It's a pretty good looking kick. Curry feels it He decides not to field it at the 18, and it rolls all the way down to the Hampton 12-yard line, where it'll belong to the Crabbers, first and 10. Let's go down to the sidelines at Beth Med.
Rick Allison, Hampton High Band Director. Rick, I know it has been a really busy season, and your halftime performance was exciting, but it doesn't end here, does it?
No, it doesn't. We leave after we finish the game here and go downtown Hampton to the Hampton Holidays Parade. And then we have a Christmas performance coming up in 2 weeks on the 19th. And our Winter Guard has already started working to get ready for their shows, and we've got 3 competitions coming up next month, and the one in February. So it doesn't stop here. We keep going.
Okay, you said you have a holiday performance on the 19th. What's the time on it?
It starts at 7 o'clock at Hampton Hall Auditorium, and we have a concert band and the jazz ensemble and percussion ensemble along with the choral department. So we've got a lot of good things happening coming up.
Great, great. Hope everybody can go out and support the Hampton Crabbers. You're here for the game. Well, they never stop entertaining us, so hope everybody can go out. Thanks.
All right, thank you, Bev. Gain of 1 yard on the last play, Chris Ricks. Second down and 9 for the Crabbers. Ball marked at their 13-yard line. Curry with play action. Wants to go long. Hawkins is the intended receiver. Good coverage downfield. Hawkins was covered nicely. No contact. And the man covering was Radin Vereen for EC Glass.
But, Tim, that was if that ball would have been thrown to the outside, he would have been able to get it, but that was a long throw. That ball had to be 50, 60 yards in the air.
and a good heavy crosswind blowing this afternoon. And in fact, the wind would appear to be blowing a little bit to the backs of the Crabbers for this quarter. But again, it's going as much across the field as it is down the field. So that stops the clock with 7:35 remaining in the third quarter, and it's third down and 9 for Hampton. Crawford comes wide to the near side, double wide receivers to the left. Curry feels the pressure, gets away from a would-be tackler, has a little bit of running room, tries to get the outside, a good block. Kenny Crawford with a good block, and Curry was out of bounds for a first down.
That was an awesome block. Young man may be hurt. Let's hope he just got the wind knocked out of him.
Telly Tucker was nailed by Kenny Crawford at about the 18-yard line. The Hampton crowd, knowing the block was a great one, applauding and standing to give the home crowd a standing ovation. Watch this now. You're going to see Curry at his best. This is the way Curry scrambles around. Now watch this block on number 3 right here. Boom! Kenny Crawford nailed the would-be tackler, Telly Tucker. And Tucker, we're very happy to say, is able to come off. He just had the wind knocked out of him.
And I think that's what it was, Tim. But you know, he had Curry in his sights. I'm going to make the tackle. All of a sudden, it's out of nowhere. He was blindsided. Great block.
Kenny Crawford, and this is the way Hampton block. This is the way they get here. This is how you get to the state championship. You don't just make your block and then watch the rest of the play. You keep blocking all the way. And with Curry,
he went out
to scramble.
He was out on a pass pattern.
Yep. Hand off to Chris Ricks, and Ricks gets nothing. In on the stop, amongst others, was number 44, George Brown, for the Hilltoppers.
Well, one thing about the Hampton Crabbers is the young men are always prepared for the game. The coaches do a great job. The coaching staff does. But they also know that you have other responsibilities. If you're a receiver, that's not the only thing you do. You also have to block. You have to look at situations. I mean, you've got to be aware of what's going on in football. You have to have football sense.
Second down and 11 for the Crabbers. Curry scrambling. And is taken down. He is sacked at the 22-yard line as the Hilltoppers do a good job of containing Ronald Curry. One of the few times in this ball game that Curry has been thrown for a loss.
Well, you got to take your hats off to this defensive front line of the Hilltoppers, Tim. They only rush for the most part 4 men. Sometimes they'll send some linebackers, but they put a lot of pressure on the quarterback as we saw in that last play. As you can watch on this replay, there's just nowhere for young Ron Curry to go. And now Hampton is in their shotgun.
Third down and long, Chris Ricks in motion. Out of the shotgun, wide open is Blizzard. He makes the grab. He's got the first down at the 40. He may go. He's got one man to meet. Bobby Blizzard still on his feet. All the way down to the 1-yard line.
Oh, what a nice catch and run by Bobby Blizzard. He wanted that touchdown so kind of bad. Right when you think you got Hampton and you got him back in a hole, boom, they come up. And how long was that play?
It had been third down and 15 to go. It is now first and goal at the 2-yard line.
He's saying 86 yards. I don't know if it was quite 86 yards because it looked like it was about, well, that may have been.
Yep.
But whatever.
80 plus.
Yeah, it was excellent.
Once again, Ronald Curry with the pinpoint pass. Bobby Blizzard with the great run after the catch. And the Crabbers knocking on the door again. First and goal, right side, in the air. No indication yet. They're going to say he was stopped. The second effort was after the whistle had blown.
Well, I tell you, you almost have to give it to young Mr. Ricks for effort because he sure wanted out bad.
So Chris Ricks is denied the end zone. He is stopped at the 1-yard line. The whistle had blown before his second effort to let him get in. So the play stops at the 1. Backfield of
Smith.
Oh, that was a quarterback keeper.
Ronald Curry for the touchdown. That, by the way, for Ron Curry is his 11th running touchdown of the season to go along with his 19 pass touchdowns. Shepard will try the extra point. Travers leading 27-7. High snap. The kick is up and the kick is good.
It's not pretty, but it doesn't make any difference.
So there you see the ecstatic Hampton side of the field as the Travers have gone out on top 28-7 with 4:41 remaining in the third quarter.
Every time today, EC Glass has come up with a great play defensively. The next play, Hampton has just said, in your face.
Listen, just listen to the crowd. Let's go down to the sideline at Bev Penn.
Anthony Reed, the class of 1981. Anthony, the score is now 28-7. Hampton scored again. What do you think about it? What's going to happen?
Well, we're just blowing them out now. It seems like back in 81 when I graduated, we blew all the teams out. So this is just a repeat of what happened in 81. I'm just glad to be here.
Absolutely. It's just been happening since. This is so exciting because I was back in the day, too. So I know Hampton's always winning.
Yeah, we always come up with a good team. This year, we got a great quarterback. I think that makes the difference this year. So, I mean, there's no stopping us. Everybody can go home now, right now. We know we've won this. You know, no turning back now.
All right, no turning back. We're going to turn it back over to the guys.
All right, thank you, Bev.
Ball 78 carry. Yards on that last touchdown, Tim, just to let you know. It was 78 yards.
That was the drive. Cedric Johnson returned the kickoff. Warm up the bus. I love it. That says it all.
I tell you, you know that the fans don't even feel the cold now.
Yep, the Hampton Crabbers looking for their first title since 1988, their 13th overall. And they have owned EC Glass. Kendrick on the draw play, gives to Matthews, and Matthews gets a couple of yards, and that's about all. The Hampton defense, of course, is just as pumped as they can be after the offense has done the job. Ronald Curry with the long pass and catch to Bobby Blizzard, setting up the one-yard run from Ronald Curry to make it 28-7 here in the third quarter.
And you can see the Crabbers are really gang-tackling now, too, Tim. I mean, when the ball carrier gets to the line of scrimmage, it's not one red jersey around. There's a lot of red jerseys around.
Double wide receivers to the near side for the Hilltoppers. Kendrick looks that way, fakes the short pass, now gets some pressure. Kendrick, good job of evading tacklers, and then he's hit well out of bounds. I wouldn't be surprised to see a late flag come down, but yet none has come. Kendrick was clearly out of bounds, but...
Well, that was a good run by Hendricks. Tim, there's nobody open, and when he has to wait long enough for somebody to get open, he's got pressure.
Here's the replay. We'll see this again. Kendrick does a great job of evading tacklers. He wanted to go short. Then he decided to look long, but then he says, wait a minute, let me just run for some daylight here. Did a good job with the footing as bad as it is.
Really did.
And again, it rained all night long before the game here, but the field at Todd Stadium in as good a shape as it could possibly be. Kendrick is missed by Donnie Green. Kendrick trying to get the first down, does so on a nice effort out across the 38 to almost the 39-yard line.
Run out of bounds over there by linebacker Hollier.
You know what? I've been so wrapped up in this game, I haven't talked about third quarter advertisers. Our Zoom Sitco. Again, we want to thank the fine folks at Zoom Sitco for supporting all of our cable casts this year. And Hampton Chevrolet. In Hampton, again, our thanks to these fine business establishments for supporting Channel 5's coverage of high school sports. 3:23 remaining here in the third quarter. Hampton leading by the score of 28-7. Now a timeout has been requested by
by the Hilltoppers of EC Glass.
Well, we do want to thank Tom Gear and Gear Printing for their help in helping to sponsor the games all year, and along with Forbes and Broadwell, who specialize in personal injuries, lawyers that have done a great job. They're located in Hampton. We appreciate those, too.
All right, let's go down to the sidelines at Beth Fed.
Let me get you to move to your... Dean Austin and Geraldine, you tell me that you had a son that played on a team?
Yes, I did, 4 years. He graduated in 95, June of 95.
So what do you have to say for all of the people that are watching, and especially to, are we going to say this is going to be a championship team?
Sure. All the way.
All the way. So what do you all want to tell the crab?
Crabbers! Go Crabbers! Go Crabbers! Go
Crabbers! You think she's on the Crabber side of the field.
Man was wearing a blue jacket, but that's not significant of where he's supporting his teams.
There you go.
Hilltoppers are blue and white, but that's not where that man's backing up. First down for the Hilltoppers at the 39-yard line. Kendrick rolling and looking, has some time, now throws and completes the pass. A short gain to about the 44-yard line.
And that was big 84 that caught him. Marcus Banks, Tim. He's 6'5". He's a big kid. I don't have some statistics on him.
Well, Banks was their leading receiver with 33 catches for better than 500 yards and six touchdowns during the season for the Hilltoppers, but he has been a non-factor today.
Well, has all the receivers,
yep,
except for the
hand. Only the second catch by a Hilltopper. Clock stops at 3:17, second down at about 4. Now on the opposite, the pitch goes to Matthews, and Matthews gets out to midfield, and that'll be enough for a first down.
I'll tell you, I'm real impressed with Mark Baycote that time. Mark Baycote got blocked, was out of position, and still ended up making the tackle.
As of equal value, I think it should be noted that Baycote has been playing hurt for a lot of this season, and that's how you get championship teams. Your good players play hurt. They play under any circumstance. Here's the replay. You're going to see
right, Baycote. He's being blocked. Yep. He turned it inside. What is his responsibility?
And
so he wasn't out
job.
Of position at all.
First down for the Hilltoppers. This is Chris Matthews, and Matthews crosses midfield to about the Hampton 48-yard line, a gain of a couple. But the Hilltoppers can do this all afternoon as far as the Crabbers are concerned. They can wind that clock down and run the ball on every down if they want.
They're going to have to get some quick scores and then stop Hampton.
Something they haven't been able to do.
Right, and they have not. Right, the only quick score they got is on that fumble in their early part of that first quarter by the Crabbers. Had great field position.
Again, Matthews gets the call, and he drags Hampton tacklers for another first down. So Chris Matthews with an excellent effort this afternoon. As I mentioned, this young man had 1,501 yards on the season coming into this game and has added significant numbers to that total again. He's a fine-looking running back, is Matthews. Matthews, by the way, is a senior for the Hilltoppers. All right, another first down for the Hilltoppers at the Hampton 40-yard line. Andre Hendrick, the quarterback. Play action on the option, cuts it upside, gets inside of the 30 to the 25, and is dragged out of bounds at about the 17-yard line, where it'll be another first down for EC Glass.
Well, that's one of the places that Kendrick has got a lot of yards all year long, has been on that option play.
All right, to the sidelines, Beth Penn.
With Stan Jones, and I understand that you had two sons who were Crabbers in this very same tradition out there on the field.
Oh, yes. All right. That's right.
Okay. Tell me your son's name and their years, the years that they played and graduated.
Okay. Stanley, the first son, played last year was 78-79, and he played on the 77 championship team. Mm-hmm. And Sherwood, the youngest son, played from 84 to 87, and he played on in four state championship games, and he played on two state championship teams, which was 85 and 86.
Okay, well, good. So what's your prediction for today? Are you excited? I know that you know what's going to happen. What's going to happen?
I'm excited, and I'm hoping Hampton will win the game, and there'll be good sportsmanship all the way throughout the game, and they'll be to come out the victorious.
All right, Thank you, Bev. Matthews on the afternoon now. 17 carries, 87 yards for Chris Matthews. On that last play, you may have seen the sack. Just as he was being sacked, he threw the ball.
Forward pass, intentional grounding against the offense. Loss it down.
So you heard Andy Keel tell you an intentional grounding call as he was about to be sacked. He threw the ball, and it was ruled to be intentional grounding. So it's not only the loss on the play, but a loss of down.
Donnie Green
with a big pressure. Second down and about 22 for the Hilltoppers. Kendrick on the reverse. Good looking play, but it doesn't do anything on the yardage.
Grabbers did a great job of turning that inside, and that was McKenzie along with Crawford, and I don't know who the third one was over there.
That was a misdirection play. Looked like it might work for a moment there, but the Crabbers had that one read perfectly.
Watch this. And right there, they're turning it inside, and that's what you got to do.
Nobody was fooled on the right side of the defensive line for Hampton. So we are down to a minute and four remaining in the third quarter.
We got double receivers to the top of the field, the top of the screen.
Kendrick on play action, looking, has time, throws. He's got a man at the goal line that's tipped away at the last second on a great defensive effort by both McKenzie and Curry. Either one or both of them got a hand on it.
Well, they looking at each other and says, we did it. Great job.
So that brings up now a fourth down and 22.
And you got to go for it, Tim. You're almost out of the third quarter. If you're EC Glass, kicking the ball is not going to do any good. Field goal is not going to do any good.
Watch the replay. This is from the ground level. Kendrick has time now and throws, and two Hampton players had a better shot at it than did the intended receiver, Thacker. So it is fourth down and 22. High formation. Kendrick has, again, double wide receivers to the far side of the field. Play action. Kendrick looking, rolling, now throws. He's got a man open, but that will be incomplete. He is out of bounds. Out of bounds, the catch made by Hunter, but he was on, or at least out of bounds when he caught it, so it goes over and down.
He was out of bounds when he went up, Tim. Yep. That was a tough pass from that position. It was thrown all the way across the field. And Donnie Green in front of you throwing his hands up in the air, waving. You got to even throw it higher, probably.
Kendrick is listed, depending on where you read his listed, but about 5'10", which is not very tall in this day and age of the big quarterbacks. And when you've got Donnie Green at 6'4", 6'5", with those long arms waving in front of your face, I gave Green 2 inches more height than he has. He plays like he's 6'4", but he is, in fact, 6'2". All right, the Crabbers back on offense. This is Smith, and Smith dragging Hilltoppers out to the 35-yard line.
He wasn't denied. He was hit two or three times at about the 31, 32, and he took it to the 36.
Darrell Smith with an 8-yard gain on the play. Second down and two. We're down to 20 seconds remaining in the third quarter. This will very well be the last play of the quarter if they get it off. Of course, the Crabbers right now want to do nothing but burn up the time. They lead 28-7 with 5 seconds and the clock moving. They'll get the play off. Play action fake. Curry has some running room, gets a block downfield, and then is knocked out of bounds as the time expires for the third quarter at the 49-yard line, and that'll be another Hampton first down. Let's listen to the crowd.
They have it.
Successful programs in the state of Virginia on any sport event, but certainly in football, it's been Hampton now for a number of years, and they're proving it again this afternoon.
I would even venture to say probably one of the most successful programs in the United States that Mike Smith and his staff has put together here over the last 20-some-odd years. What a great job. That last play is kind of indicative of what's going on. Everybody in the stands and the defense knew it was going to be a pop right up the middle. All Curry did was fake that, take it on a naked bootleg, went around the right side, picked up a first down, and just changed quarters.
So as we enter the fourth quarter, our score, Hampton 28, EC Glass 7. Grabbers led 21-7 at halftime.
Buried you. Oh, Scotty's working on his anniversary. We'll have to talk about that.
Handoff goes to Smith, and Smith is across midfield to about the EC Glass 49-yard line.
What did he say, 23 years
23
ago?
23 years ago on a day similar as this.
Similar to this, where Hampton was winning, Scotty and Diane Bowers tied the knot. And he said that Diane made a mistake.
Yeah, that's what he said.
Well, she straightened him out, hasn't she? Congratulations, Scotty. 23
and,
years.
And Diane, especially for putting up with Scotty for 23 years. Officials, stoppage of the clock. We have an equipment problem with one of the Hampton players, it appears. 11:27 remaining.
No, it's number three for the
three? Okay.
Last team. I was looking for the Hampton player too, and then number three is walking off the side.
Telly
again,
Tucker.
We do want to thank Tom Gear, Gear Up Printing, for all their help in helping to sponsor the game, and of course the Lifeline, who's got a special just for the people watching this game. You get down there, limited time only. Appreciate their support.
So Tucker probably still trying to get the ringing noise out of his ear from that block. Man, that
you think that's what
that Crawford put on him. He probably finally now just realized where he was.
They turned the helmet around on him.
Until now.
Hawkins coming to the near side. The pitch goes to Chris Ricks, and Ricks is grabbed from behind on a good defensive effort by the young man who would get my vote for player of the game so far for EC Glass, and that's Chris Matthews, number 20. He has been superb with the ball, and this time showing his defensive efforts.
Right, and we got to come up with a player of the game for the Hampton Crabbers, Tim, and you've got most of the statistics over there, so you know I'm going to let you help me with it.
By the
Watch
way,
talk last play.
This is the replay of the last play, the fake pitch, and then the toss to Ricks, and a good effort by Matthews to bring him down. By the way, well, just after this play, I'll tell you a little bit about Ronald Curry. That has gone on this afternoon. 222 yards, 2 touchdowns, 5 out of 9 with no INTs. The pitch fumbled, and it looks like Glass may have come up with it. They have. EC Glass gets the turnover. So the Crabbers, again, uncharacteristically fumbling the ball here, and they've given the ball to EC Glass at the Glass 48-yard line. 10:26, the clock is now moving. Here's the replay of the last play. You see the pitch, and he just never had it.
No, it was a little bit behind him, but he had his hands on it. Should have come up with it.
Hey,
that happens. We got trips to the right and a single to the left, Tim, so we got four wide receivers.
Out of the shotgun, Kendrick has plenty of time to look over the field, but now the time runs out on him. Donnie Green has him in a bear hug.
You're not going to get away if Donnie Green gets a hold of you.
The sack all the way back to the 40-yard line, a 9-yard loss on the play. Donnie Green, who has just been the opposing team's worst nightmare when it comes to the defense. Second down and 19. Kendrick again from the shotgun. Green trying to get to him, can't. Pass is thrown and intercepted. No, Curry couldn't hold on to it. Curry on his knees at the 34-yard line.
He had it long enough, didn't he, Tim?
Yeah, it seems like
hands
he did.
Was on the knees.
Seemed like he might have been in possession of it. I guess he never really controlled it.
Well, he had it as long as a young man in the Deep Creek game a year ago.
Well, you know, the problem here, much like that call, is his back was between us. Or he was That's between true. Us and the ball, so he may have been bobbling the ball. So, nonetheless, it's third down and 19 for the Hilltoppers. Kendrick out of the shotgun, throws, almost picked off by McKenzie. So the EC Glass quarterback having a horrible afternoon passing the ball.
I don't know what Bobby's got for his statistics, but I know he's completed almost as many passes to Hampton as he does his own team.
Yeah, and the EC Glass have to punt at this position. You can't give the ball to Hampton on their own 40. Let's see if Bob Killen does have the statistics. Ron, hey,
that's Larry Malloy.
Larry Malloy.
He's up here to check out the Todd Field. There's Larry Malloy and his group do such a great job at Darling Stadium. Ronald Curry thought about fielding that punt, now backs away from it, and after a sea of blue and white jerseys, he decides to let the ball roll dead at the 10.
I'm impressed with that Harrington. That young man has done a good job. And you see the color jacket the young man's got on. He can come to this game and pull for the team he wants to, but when he's at Darling Stadium, he can't do that.
He wears that neutral color at Darling, right? All right, the Crabbers now will get the ball with 9:08 left here in the championship game. Hampton leading 28-7 in quest of their 13th state title and their first since 1988. Tim Cole along with Bob Hintz coming to you from Todd Stadium here on the 9th of December, 1995. Curry has the ball, rolls, looks, wants more. Throws long, Crawford got it! What a catch!
What a jump! I can't believe this.
Kenny Crawford got a hand on it. The ball popped up in the air, and he had the presence of mind to dive again and make the grab.
Tim, look over on the other side, and those people are stunned over there. They just cannot believe this Hampton Crabber team.
All right, we'll take a break in just a moment. I guess we've got time for one more before we do a tape change, Scotty. 8:41, the clock has restarted. Kenny Crawford on the receiving end. A great pass from Ron Curry to Crawford for the first down at the Hampton 45-yard line. Ronald Curry over center, out of the I formation. Hand off to Chris Ricks, second man. Ricks, near side, across midfield to the 49-yard line. All right, we'll return to Todd Stadium with the conclusion of our championship coverage after this brief timeout. All right, back to the live action. Second down at about 4. Flag down, one of the few this afternoon. There have not been a lot of penalties.
Premature movement, I believe, that they've blown it dead.
We were just looking at the statistics for Kendrick, and we'll Kendrick on the afternoon, 1 of 11.
Prior to the snap, offense false start.
Watch this.
Replay down.
Watch Crawford stay with the ball. What a great effort! He tips the ball in the air, catches it again. But Kendrick on the afternoon, just one completion for 6 yards and 3 INTs. This young man comes into the game better than 60% of his passes for 20 touchdowns and 1,600 yards. So have the Hampton Crabbers defense done the job? You bet they have.
Well, Tim, I at the beginning of the year, everybody had said the Crabbers were, you know, they were in bad shape because they lost that first game. But I told you to go back to 1988 when Hampton went over and played Tab, lost that first game, did not lose another game, and won the state championship. I said, watch them. They're going to do the same thing, and they did.
Kenny Crawford making a more conventional catch at the 39-yard line. On his knees, he got, you know, that's one of those plays. He went just enough for the first down, turned. Curry threw it right on the numbers. First down, Hampton. Hilltoppers 39, 7 minutes remaining. Clock is moving. Hampton under control. Inside handoff for Darryl Smith. Smith gets, well, he's still on his feet. He's still not down. He's all the way to the 30. He's still moving to the 28-yard line.
My goodness. How do you bring that guy down, Tim?
You need two more tacklers is what you need. Another first down for the Crabbers. They move it all the way to the 26. There you see Ronald Curry.
That's young Brian Smith. Mike Smith's young son. It's just unbelievable.
Watch the replay here. They're going to see Smith. He is stopped right here. Boom. He stopped there. No? No, he's not. He keeps going. Stop
watch
here, right?
Legs.
No,
watch
not there
legs.
Either. No, not there either.
He never stopped moving.
First down at the Hampton, or rather at the EC Glass 26. And stacked up for no gain this time is Smith, as he never even got a chance to get the wheels turning. 6 out of 11 for Curry now on the afternoon. 267 yards and 2 touchdowns. And he scored one himself on the ground as well. Ronald Curry back from the sideline where he has gotten the play for Mike Smith and the rest of the staff. Watching Mark Mako down the sideline, he is hot about something.
He wants to get in.
I think that's what it is.
Offensively.
I think that's what it is. He says, blame me on offense, coach. Second and 10, Curry throwing to Kenny Crawford at the end zone, and it's batted away, incomplete. Good coverage by the Hilltoppers. Never really had a chance at that ball.
Well, that was had just a little too much air underneath it. It floated a little too much. Crawford had run a great pattern, was open, but the ball was just a little short.
5.5 minutes to go in the season. And again, we want to make sure we have thanked all the appropriate sponsors. Hampton Chevrolet, again, we take our hats off to the folks at Hampton Chevrolet for sponsoring our coverage. And again, they urge you to contribute to the Daily Press Holiday Fund. Third and 10, Curry has time. Now starts to scramble, gets away from one man, now throws deep in the end zone is Crawford, and that ball is picked off, but it's out of bounds. They simply ran out of real estate in the end zone.
Well, it looked like Ron Curry was going to get tackled, and he was stopped. It looked like he was going to run out of bounds, and he still made the throw.
So brings up
fourth down.
Fourth down at 10. And again, we want to thank Zoom Sitco, a community leader for promoting academic excellence. Here's the replay of the last action. You're going to see Curry with lots of time, now starts to feel the pressure, backs up and then throws, and as I said, got a receiver there, but he was well covered and no more room in the end zone. So fourth down and 10. Chris Ricks in motion to the right. Curry has time over the middle, completes it to Blizzard, and Blizzard will be close to a first down, but it'll depend on the mark. I don't think he got it. He may have missed it by about a half a football length. They mark it at the 17. They'll bring the chains out, but it looks to the yard mark on the far side that he needed to cross the 17. Now I'm going to guess on this one, Bob, that he missed it by about an inch.
Okay, you've been eagle-eyed for so long.
Yeah, but I haven't done well this year, so this is my chance to redeem myself. They'll get the chain. They'll try and stretch it out.
Football length.
Yep, so a big inch. So at least I had the right call, but yep. I was wrong on the distance. So the Crabbers will give the ball over to the Hilltoppers, but not particularly of any great consequence, as this game is all but over with 5:14 remaining, and we hope to have a lot of post-game interviews. In fact, Bob will be down on the field for post-game interviews at the conclusion. And Bobby Blizzard this afternoon, 3 catches for 108 yards. Direct snap to the shotgun quarterback. Matthews gets away after the toss, and he has one man to get by. That's Ronald Curry chasing him down, and he'll bulldog him down at the 45-yard line.
He's a tough runner, the Matthews.
Matthews is a good-looking young man with the ball. He has really impressed me this afternoon. 5'10 senior. So the Crabber defense gives up some yards. Go ahead, Bev.
With Bill Steele. And Bill, you were with the music department for many years with our school system. It is really good to see you out supporting the Hampton Crabbers.
Never stop supporting them. They're the greatest. They win them all the time, and I like to be at the games when they win.
I know if you look back over the years, it's like every year, here we are, back again.
Yeah, and it's good to see that Hampton band getting better, too. They look mighty good today.
That's good. It's really good to have you out.
All right, the incomplete pass almost picked off by the Crabber secondary. Stops the clock with 4:42 remaining.
Ronald Curry got a hand on that, Tim. There was 29 yards on that last run by young
by
Mr.
Matthews.
Matthews.
Right.
Trips ever to since, the right.
Ever since EC Glass scored to open the scoring in this game, they have not again dented the board. Trips to the right side. Kendrick feels the pressure, and it goes down. And that is number 70, big 7-0, William Perry for the Crabbers. There is what they're here to play for, the big trophy on the right. That is the state championship trophy, and the Crabbers are a little more than 4 minutes away from it. Kendrick steps up, now finds some running room, and he is dragged out of bounds, but he will not have a first down. That'll bring up a fourth down and about eight to go for the Hilltoppers. We want to take this opportunity before all the madness that will occur shortly to thank all the fine folks here at Todd Stadium for all the cooperation and our setup for this afternoon. I know Scotty Bowers, our director, can certainly appreciate their efforts. Also, Gary Selby is the person we want to give specific thanks to, and we really do appreciate all the assistance given to us. Fourth down and eight, as Matthews on the afternoon now has 18 carries for 115 yards for the Hilltoppers. Motion on the defensive side of the ball. Looks like the Crabbers might have jumped, but that would not be enough for a first down. And let's go back down to the sideline. Bev?
I'm with Bill Wood, and Bill, today is special for you because you have three generations of your family here.
Yes, I do. I have a granddaughter, my daughter, and myself. There's three of us.
Winning is a tradition for you. You were saying that you were on which championship team? You played
1936. I played football from 33 through 36 at Hampton High School.
Okay, well, it's good to see you out there. And I know we're going to have another picture, so you can put that one in your cap, too.
Next year, I hope to have a reunion of all of our championship football players. I've got about 20 of the 36 boys still around, and I hope to have them back with all the others.
Okay.
That will be my celebration next year.
All right, the illegal procedure penalty against the Hilltoppers. Almost caught as Darnell Hilliard had a shot at it, but couldn't come up with the INT, but it goes over on downs, and a Crabber is shaken up on the play.
And that's number 66, Tim. That's Massenburg.
That's Massenburg. He is down at midfield, but the ball does go over to Hampton on downs, and hopefully Massenburg will be able to get off on his own here. He may have just had the wind knocked out. 4:06 to go. Some of the crowd, predominantly the crowd from EC Glass, making their ways to the exits, but the Hampton Crabbers fans are staying here to relish this as Massenburg is able to come off. Here's the replay. We're going to see Kendrick throwing into coverage as
that's Darnell Hollier.
Oh, Hollier. I said Hilliard. Hollier is what I meant to say. But Massenburg is okay. He comes out, and the Crabbers will go back on offense from their 49-yard line.
Let's go to Bev.
We can't say that winning is a tradition at Hampton enough, because this is Terrence Howell. Terrence was on the 1981 championship team. What position did you play, and what's the difference between the teams, and Hampton still winning, so it can't be that much, but it's maybe something small.
Well, first of all, I played tight end for Hampton, and it's not too much of a difference between the two teams, except in size. They're still doing the jobs that they're capable of doing, and that's going out there playing good defense, executing well on offense and on special teams. And if you're playing well in all three phases of the game, you're going to win big football games.
Then, and I think today is safe to say, what is 3:42 on the clock?
Yes.
Another victory.
Another victory, another state championship for Hampton. And I'm going to tip my hat off to Coach Smith and his coaching staff, who did a heck of a job preparing this football team for an excellent season.
All right, back to the live action. Smith is the ball carrier. He gets close to the first down. It was second at about three. And they'll, depending on where they mark the ball, looks like it might be just short of the first. They may even bring the chains in, although I think referee Neal is going to assume it's not going to be a first down. We understand that there will be a presentation of the trophy immediately following the game. All right, we have a stoppage in play. A timeout has been called. 2 seconds less than 3 minutes to go in the season. The Hampton Crabbers will win their 13th state championship, their first since 1988. Crabbers last met EC Glass. One of the little-known facts, they met him in 1968. Was the last time this team played EC Glass, and they won 13-0 in that contest. And Hampton leads the overall series 8-4. Now make that 9-4. The Hampton coaches making their way down to the sideline from the press box here. They jubilant to say the least. Go ahead down to the sidelines, Scotty.
This is Ernest Howell, and you tell me you were on the 83 championship team. What position did you play, and tell us about that team?
That was an unusual team, but to me, that team was like unstoppable. The position that I played, you know, I set a lot of ruckus, but I want to see it broken, but I don't think it's going to happen.
Number one, it's unstoppable.
Oh, yeah, there's a lot of talent out there. I watched them a few times, and I think that this team right here can win it 3 years in a row.
Darrell Smith with the touchdown. Burst right up the middle. We saw this play against Deep Creek. 41 yards for Darrell Smith, and the touchdown to make it 34-7 in favor of the Crabbers. They are nailing the lid shut with less than 3 minutes to go here at Todd Stadium. Shepherd will try the extra point. The kick is up, it is long enough, and it is through the uprights. So the Hampton Crabbers have extended their lead now to just a plain old whipping, 35-7. Here's your replay. You're gonna watch this. This is what the Crabbers have used, this quick hitter. And Smith has been incredibly effective with this play. And this time he races 41 yards for his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Hampton Crabbers have just dotted the I in the word championship. They are the state champs. We understand that Bob has made his way down to the sidelines. And Bob has asked me to come up with the player of the game for the Hampton Crabbers, and you talk about a tough task to do. But I'm going to have to give the game ball and the championship and the player of the game to the sophomore sensation at quarterback, Ronald Curry, as he, amongst many others, could be considered. Hawkins with the 86-yard grab, Crawford with a touchdown and a great effort on the afternoon on several occasions. Darrell Smith with two touchdowns, but Curry throws for two and runs for another. And Ronald Curry will be our player of the game, and for that matter, the player of the state for the state of Virginia, in my opinion. He is going to be something special and already is. Kendrick returning the kickoff. Kendrick, who coming into this game, just was a phenomenal success for EC Glass, but the Crabber defense has shut him down. He has been totally ineffective passing the ball and has had just limited success when trying to run with it. 2.5 minutes remaining in the season. The Crabbers comfortably on top by the score of 35-7. Again, we invite you to stay tuned after the ball game. We will have the presentation of the trophy, and Bob will have as many post-game interviews as we can get. We'll interview him until the cows come home. Kendrick looks over the defense and calls timeout as he found something that he needed to make an adjustment to. But it has been a superb afternoon for both sides of the Hampton team. The defense led by Donnie Green, Hollier by Mark Baycote. Baycote with an interception, Ronald Curry with an interception. Curry, of course, the quarterback on offense and the safety on defense. And Mike Smith has just enjoyed, maybe enjoyed is the wrong word, just endured a Gatorade bath as the team has doused him. And he will want to get into dry clothes soon after this game because it is a chilly afternoon. But I guarantee you right now, the red and white on the near sideline here has enjoyed every second of this ball game. The crowd's still hanging around for the final conclusion of this game. 2:11 is the time remaining. The Hilltoppers first and 10 from their 31-yard line. Andre Kendrick, I formation for EC Glass. Hand off to Chris Matthews, and Matthews will pick up 5. Out to about the 36. The Hampton Crabbers
lost the first game of the year to Kekatan in a monsoon. Weather could not have been worse for that game. In fact, that game was held up for about a half an hour to allow the lightning and the thunder to subside. And the Grabbers lost that game and never looked back after that as they steamrolled over their opponents from that point on, and they will win the Division V state championship. Clock moving down to a minute 35. Kendrick throws the short pass. It is complete. And out of bounds at the 42-yard line. That is number 45, Todd DeLamalure, who we mentioned several times in the early going, but he has been a non-factor ever since then. And again, that's what the Hampton defense has done to teams this year. They've taken the opponent's key players and have shut them down. There you see the shirt. Hampton State Champions 1995. That one has still got the ink drying on it. And that says it all, folks. Down to a minute 28. The clock stopped with the out-of-bounds play. First down for the Hilltoppers. This is Matthews, and Matthews breaks into the open and finally dragged down at the Hampton 36-yard line. Another first down for the Hilltoppers, but this is all of no great consequence. The Crabbers have this game all salted away. This will only make the statistics for the Hilltoppers look a little better, but that's about all. And of course, they would love nothing better than to score one more time. Grabbers shuffling in some new faces on defense. Want to give these guys a chance to get some championship exposure. Down the field, incomplete. On the far sideline, the intended receiver was Steve Coffey, number 27. There's Trish Mitchell. She is the athletic director at Hampton High School, and she is showing you the shirt that the Hampton Crabbers will be wearing with great pride. Matthews on the afternoon now, 20 carries for 143 yards, and he has been the lone bright spot in the lineup for EC Glass this afternoon. We're inside of a minute to go. 35-7. Hampton will win the state championship. This is Matthews, and Matthews still on his feet, gets another big gainer, almost enough for a first down. He'll be shy by a couple of yards. But the clock is moving. The Crabbers defense with a lot of new numbers in there. Some of the players that I want to recognize that don't get a lot of playing time. Aubrey Royal, number 40, is out there along with number 22, Thelonious Cook. In the middle, 41, Jason Chesser. Kendrick looking, now running, and Kendrick still on his feet. Down close to the 11-yard line with 14 seconds remaining. The clock stops with the chains being advanced for the first down. So the Hilltoppers will get at least another playoff. If, in fact, they choose to even do so. Now they're taking time out to make sure they get another shot. 14 seconds. Let me, again, continue to try and recognize some of the players on the field. These guys practice hard all year long and don't get the playing time. But that's not because of a lack of effort. Andre Jones, number 11, is out there. As I mentioned, 22, Thelonious Cook. Looks like number 8, Martin Tinsley Jr. out there as well. Number 82 also on the field. That's Gary Freeman. He's a junior. 31 in the middle, William D. Harris. He's a sophomore. 87, Jarrett Green. Number 71 out there, that's Daryl Mitchell. And please forgive me if I miss some of these gentlemen whose jerseys are nice and clean because they have been on the bench. Gary Reeves also out on the field now for the Crabbers. And Marcus Smith, number 77. So the Crabber defense is all new. They are out there. Mike Smith giving these guys a chance to play in the state championship game. This could be the final play of the game. 14 seconds remaining. Kendrick looking, wants to throw in the end zone, gets some pressure, throws, and it is incomplete, intended for DeLamalure, who got a hand on it, but that stops the clock with 6 seconds remaining. So the Hilltoppers will have at least one more chance. And all of this, of course, is just delaying the inevitable. We want to thank, amongst others, our great crew, Channel 5 crew today, our camera people on slow-mo, of course, was Jerome Young. Braxton, one of our camera people. Bev Penn for her interviews. And, of course, our director and producer, Scotty Bowers, in the end zone. It is incomplete. 1 second remaining. Actually, it looked like the Crabbers might have picked that one off. But it goes incomplete, and the Hilltoppers will have one last shot at trying to get a score with 1 second to go. The Crabbers. Here's the last play we were talking about. It looked like that ball was picked off, but the official there, with a much better point of view than we have, ruled the ball hit the ground incomplete. So Kendrick and company, one last chance here. 1 second remaining in the ball game. They'll give it to Chris Matthews. Matthews is down close to the goal line. He will not get in, and that will make Hampton the state champions. Let's just watch and listen. Champions, the Hampton Crabbers, enjoying themselves as well they should. It's been a terrific season. The Hampton Crabbers will finish 14-1, and that graphic says it all as you see the pride of Hampton High School, the marching band, as they celebrate along with the cheerleaders and the football team and the coaching staff. This, as Bob said, started way back in the hot days of August. And the Hampton Crabbers worked hard all year long and finally got their victory they've been looking for, the last one of the season in the state championship game. It's been a terrific ride. And most of this team, a young team, will be back next year. Ronald Curry will return. He's just a sophomore. McKenzie is a junior. Ahmad Hawkins is a junior. Kenny Crawford will not be back. He's a senior. Bobby Blizzard's just a sophomore. Donnie Green, of course, number 75 is a senior. He'll graduate. There you see number 53. That's Chris Calloway. He's a junior. He'll be back. Mark Baitcoat is a senior. He is going to be moving on. William Perry, just a sophomore. They're beating number 70. So rightly so, the Hampton team enjoying their moment as state champions.
Hey, Tim.
Yes, Bob.
I got Donnie Green.
How you doing, Bob?
I got Tim. Hey, listen, congratulations.
Thanks.
Your defense has really come up, not only you, but your whole defensive unit this year.
Oh, we had to thank Coach Mitchell and the coaches for this. It feels good. We're championship. I'm just ecstatic right now. My dad and his 76 check. But I just feel great. And we worked hard during all season, and we deserved this. Coach said we played as good as we want to, and we did it tonight.
Well, you did a great job. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, good enough. Let's run back up to Tim. I'll get somebody else.
All right, Bob. And just looking down the roster here, some of the young men that will be back, Daryl Smith,
with two touchdowns this afternoon. He's a junior. He'll be back.
I tell him I got Coach Mitchell. Danny, August, first week in August, you're talking 5 months of football. I know it's got to be worth it.
Yeah, I tell you, it is worth it. You know, you just don't realize all the work those kids put into it. It's like they think we just line up on Friday nights and Saturday night and play. They don't know all the work that we go through. And every group of kids is different. And it's always so special to see them accomplish, you know, the ultimate goal.
Well, I know that you put a lot of effort into. It's not just the kids, but the coaches put in a lot of effort.
Everybody, you know, that's one of the things at Hampton. If you're going to coach there, if you're going to play there, and I've done both, you're going to have to work. You're going to have to work to do it.
Well, we got a young crabber here. This is Matthew. Matthew, what'd you think of the ball game?
We're going to win.
He knew we were going to win.
You knew they were going to win. Well, listen, Danny, congratulations on a fine win and just a tremendous job by everybody.
You know, at the school, the city, everybody ought to be so proud of those kids. They just don't realize, you know, all the hard work coming through from that Kickatan loss. That thing seems like it was 10 years from now, you know. Hey, state championship, every one of them special. Everyone's special.
Congratulations again.
All right, thank you, Bob.
And I've got Ahmad Hawkins. Tell me about your routes that you run.
I just run straight at the field and tell everyone to throw it out there because I'll go get it.
Well, he knows where you're going. He knows what kind of speed. So you have to work on this during practice, right?
Yeah, we work on it during practice a lot. God just blessed me with speed, and I thank him for that. And I thank the coaches and it's everybody.
Well, you always come up with a big catch when it's needed. You did it in the Deep Creek game. You did it in this game. We want to congratulate you on a fine year. Just did super all year long.
Thank you.
Good enough. Thanks. We'll talk to you later. All right.
151 yards rushing this afternoon for the Crabbers on 34 carries. Ronald Curry, 277 yards passing, 8 out of 15, 2 touchdowns, 428 total yards. Go ahead, Bob.
Hey, Tim, I got an old Crabber here with me, Bud Porter. I tell you what, Bud, you got to be proud of this team.
Yes, indeed, Bob. Well, it was really nice because yesterday Mike let me come out and talk to the team. I spoke to the team, and I had an opportunity to tell them how special they were because they won 600 games this year, and they needed to play 48 tough, hard minutes to win the state championship, which is a coup de grace for 600 wins.
Well, listen, congratulations on being an alumni. I know this will happen for you.
Oh, it's great. Great.
Okay, Tim.
This, of course, the 605th victory in the long, successful years of Hampton High School. DC Glass, 41 carries, 226 yards rushing. But the big picture of this game was the passing attack. It was absolutely nullified by the Hampton defense. 2 of 17 for just 13 yards, 3 interceptions, a total offense of 239 yards for EC Glass. And, of course, Chris Matthews with the lone shining afternoon for EC Glass. Matthews with 22 carries.
Tim, I've got Elvis with me. Elvis, I got a chance to talk with Danny some. He said, you know, this has been a long season. I mean, we started back in the first week of August.
Right. It's been a long season. And after that first game, the guys, we had a good long practice on Labor Day. Never forget that practice. It was 5 hours long. And the guys came back and worked hard. And I'm glad for the kids. They really deserve it.
Well, your coaching staff, and I mentioned just you and Danny, but you got other people that help you also.
Yeah, I don't want to call no names because I'll forget somebody. All the guys are great. You guys got the list of the names, but all of them are great. Kenny Gilliam is one of the boys, and he's done a good job, and I'm not calling no more names.
Well, listen, congratulations on a fine win. I'll tell you, you make Hampton, not only the school, but the city proud of you.
Thank you very much.
Good
got
enough.
Some good kids.
Yes, you do. Okay.
All right, thank you, Bob. As I mentioned, the defense for the Crabbers did the job, and it takes that total team effort, as everybody knows. The Hampton Crabbers on offense and defense got it done.
I got Lanny here. Lanny, what's it feel like to be with the championship? I know it's almost unexplainable.
It is. I'll tell you, it's a feeling. You just one of the most tremendous feelings in the world.
Well, it's got to be, makes you feel real good to have a good group of kids to work with.
Well, that's the key to it. We've really enjoyed coaching these kids this year. They really care for each other. We just had a great time with them, so that even makes it more enjoyable.
Well, listen, congratulations.
Thanks so much.
Okay.
All right, we're going to keep having these interviews as long as Bob can find somebody who will talk to us and who's associated with the team. We're going to bring them to you. But again, the final score as Hampton wins the Division V state championship, going away by the score of 35-7. EC Glass, if you joined us real late, you missed a heck of a ball game. The EC Glass scored to open the game after Ronald Curry fumbled on the first play from scrimmage. They made it 7-0, and after that, Hampton never looked back as they rolled up the score, 35-7, over the Hilltoppers. And the Hilltoppers, once again, come out on the short end when they visit, or play, I should say, anyone from the Eastern region. Bethel handed it to them on a platter a couple of years ago. And EC Glass has yet to taste victory when, in the last 5 or 10 years, when they play a team from the eastern part of the state of Virginia. And that's where the superior play is being performed. Deep Creek, Hampton, Kingitan, Phoebus, Bethel, these teams are the class. Bob, you got somebody else to talk with down there? We have yet to see the trophy presentation. It may have already occurred. Ronald Curry is in the grasp. Of course, he's being congratulated by friend and relative and teammate alike. But Ronald Curry is just a sophomore.
Hey, Tim, I got Ron Curry. Ronald, tremendous job.
Thank you.
With the wind evidently didn't bother you at all today.
No, not much, you know. I felt that we could do this. The score should have been a lot worse, you know, because of the two turnovers we had. It feels real good to be state champion.
Well, this field is a little bit better than last week, but not a whole bunch.
No, not a whole bunch. It's still affecting me the same. And, you know, that hurt. I felt that. I felt it hurt my running game, but I had to go to the air, and we were successful doing that.
Well, it must be nice for you as a quarterback to have receivers like you have.
Yeah.
You know you put the ball up there, and they're going to go up and get it.
Yeah, they're going to go get it. You know, I praise my wide receiver. And I feel they feel the same about me. We work together 100%. Good things turn out.
Well, it did turn good things turn out. Congratulations on a fine season.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah, the line did a great job.
Well, you know, it's easy to overlook the line, but that is a great effort. Go ahead, Bob.
We got one of the unsung linemen here. Tell me a little bit about what it's like to protect a quarterback like Ronald, who does a lot of running, and also open up the holes for your good running back.
It's hard. But it's real hard. You just have to keep running. Because he'll scramble, and then you have to chase him down. So, but it's fun because, unlike other quarterbacks, he's not cocky. So he gives you your support. But blocking, you just have to give it all you have.
Well, and being a lineman, you don't get any of the glory because you don't carry the ball, but that doesn't mean you don't do a good job. You guys do a fantastic job.
Thank you. Well, we don't get any glory from the media or whatever, but our backs always have given us credit. They, no matter what, they dedicate the games to the line. And we feel that if they get 10 yards, we all got 10 yards as a team.
There you go. That's the way to think. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, both of you guys did great.
That was George Massenburg, number 66, and number 77, Marcus Smith.
Represent, baby.
Massenburg had that big fumble recovery. Had the Hampton Crabbers lost that second fumble, they could have turned this game around. But Massenburg very alertly recovered the ball for Hampton and preserved possession. And then the next play after that fumble recovery was the 86-yard pass to Ahmad Hawkins for the touchdown to make it 7-all. And after that, it was nothing but Hampton Crabbers from that point on. Going down this list, some of the guys that will be back next year for the Crabbers, and boy, that's scary. Bobby Blizzard will be back. He, of course, is an intricate part of this. Ahmad Hawkins will be back. Kadhafi McKenzie will be back. Ronald Curry will be back. Daryl Smith, Derek White, Chris Ricks is a senior, but just an endless number of key players for the Hampton Crabbers will be back next year to try and repeat as Division V champions. There you see Mike Smith, highly successful head coach for the Hampton Crabbers, and our congratulations to him and his coaching staff. You have no idea the number of hours that these coaches spend that you don't even see. You know, you see the teams come out here and play hard, and the young men put out all the effort, but the coaching staff just works endless hours trying to make this all come together, and they just do a superb job over at Hampton High School. And Mike Smith, there you see Mike Keach to the right of Mike being interviewed by a bunch of the writers here at the conclusion. Bob is going to try and get a word with Coach Smith, and we'll give him an opportunity to have a word with some of the Daily Press sports writers and other writers from the various newspapers. Only Santa and the Crabbers believe in deliverance in December. There you go. Love it. Again, we want to thank Bob Killen for doing statistics for us.
Are you surprised at how well he was able to throw the ball on such a cold day? It didn't seem to have any problem.
Well, he practiced and throws it in practice. It wasn't nearly as cold day as he'd been throwing it out that night when it's been so cold. We practice, you know, and that stuff, so. Hey, but he doesn't like cold, boy. He's the only guy I know that can't stand it much like him. I can stand it better than he can.
He's a pretty special sophomore, isn't he?
He's a special person. Not just a football player, but Ronald Curry's a special person. He's a special person. You know, all these kids are special. Ronald just, you know, and Ronald's gifted, and I hope people don't start expecting too much. He's a gifted athlete, but he works awfully hard for everything he gets. I'm telling you, he got his priorities in order. You know, he know he'd be here one day and it'd all be gone the next, but he does a good job.
Are you surprised at how lopsided the outcome was?
No. Now, I mean that. I mean, we worked hard for this thing, you know, and the only one that surprised me is last week I thought it'd be worth it. We got on that muddy field. It's a little slick here today, too, because it hurt both quarterbacks. It hurt theirs some, too, I think. But they just, you know, and he's a good quarterback. He's a great one for them. He's just not a Ronald Curry.
You've won a lot of state titles, but how does this one rate in the bunch?
Well, you saw an interview there with Coach Smith being interviewed by Channel 13, and I'm not sure who was asking the questions, but Smith was seemingly very emotional about this whole situation. He has the highest regard for this young quarterback, Ronald Curry, and as you heard him say, he's not just a special football player. He thinks Ronald Curry is a special person, and that speaks very highly for both Ron Curry and Mike Smith. So Ronald Curry has been just doing an incredible job bringing Hampton Crabber fans great delight on the football field for the last two seasons. Of course, the Crabbers went undefeated during the regular season last year, only to lose a controversial game against Deep Creek in the Eastern Regional Championship game. But this year, that was not to be a problem, as the Hampton Crabbers avenged that loss at Deep Creek.
First team all district, and the other one could have been on
that. Let's see if we can pick up who's being interviewed.
First team all district. Offense, Hawkins.
That's Mike Smith.
That's a good secondary. I mean, you know, it's hard throwing against Dan. I tell you, it's all hard throwing Donnie Green's in your face. Him and Monroe and old Bumper 70. Curry had a good game up inside that down pass lane.
How you doing, Marty?
You can see the bonding that has
occurred. My man, Marty Smith. Two-way man today.
Between these players and the coaching staff, they don't work together all the hours that they work and not become very close to each other.
It's gratifying. So you start at the beginning of August, and you go through this long a time to come up with the ultimate goal. That's what you work. But you've got some young men that are very, very special on your team.
Oh, this is a great group of kids. I mean, they've, you know, we were, we started out there and got beat that first game, and we've had playoff games every week since then.
Right, you sure have.
So they probably did the best thing that happened to us, just whip us like they did that first game and knock us around and knock the cobwebs out of our head. But, you know, at the same time, I want to thank Kurt for helping us. Kurt has helped us all through the playoffs, Kurt Newsom, and looking at films. And I bet Melinda's wife's glad it's over with. She thought he's still coaching.
Well, I know, you know, I kind of compared this game, this season, to what happened when you played Tab, when Eric was.
You know,
because you lost the first one. And
you know, it's so scary looking back at that. We lost that first game, come back and won them all. And the amazing thing was, when we won it that thing that year, it come a big snowstorm on Friday.
That's right.
You know, and it snowed on Thursday this time. But it's just scary.
Well, Michael, you know, our Hampton City, the school, everybody is just proud of you. You have a program over here that's second to none in the state and probably in the country.
Well,
you guys done a great job.
I don't think it's just us. I think all the Hampton schools got good programs, you know. And you know, you get out of the city of Hampton, you get pretty good company down there. I think they can all play with anybody.
Yeah, they do. Well, uh-huh. Again, congratulations on a fine season, Michael.
Thanks, Bob.
Okay,
appreciate
we'll
y'all being here.
Good enough. All right, Tim, let's run back up to you.
All right, thank you, Bob, and thank you, Coach Smith, for taking the time to talk with us. There you see in the middle of your picture.
Listen, we're going to talk to everybody we can. We got a proud parent here. Tell me who I have here.
I'm Little Adam Lively, small.
Oh, Little Adam, number 55. Yeah.
Right.
Well, your other son played last year.
Right, he was linebacker and fullback.
Right. Well, tell me what this has been like for you as a mama, because you had two of them playing last year, and then this year, and he's just a sophomore. You got two more years to go through.
I had a long way, and another one coming along. I'm a nervous wreck. It's been great. We've been real proud of them, and they've had it worked hard. They have worked really hard.
Well, I know they put in a lot of time, and a lot of goes off to the parents. The parents do a lot that's behind the scenes. You have supper ready at weird hours when nobody else eats, and you got to take care of all the nicks and bruises and all that, but I know it's worth it.
Well, it is, and they've worked hard, and Monday we'll have football withdrawal. That's what we call it, trying to figure out what to do with our time.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
All right, thank you, and congratulations to all the moms and dads. A bunch of proud parents going to be celebrating in the city of Hampton tonight, along with their sons and daughters. And I say daughters because the cheerleaders are a big part of this whole thing, and they certainly will enjoy this moment as much as the football players might.
Let's get all these guys in here.
Yeah, Adam.
And we're going to stick around and do some more, Bob.
O-B.
Tell me what it's like to be the center of this group.
It's great. It's great. It's like a family. It's a great family.
Well, I tell you, you guys put in a lot of time this year. You put in a lot of time.
Oh yeah, we practice 5 hours a day, every day. Practice vacations.
Hey, Jermaine,
what are you gonna do Monday?
I'm gonna still be celebrating.
There you go. Good enough. Well, here's a great team over here. Get a good look at them.
Well, that's going to do it for us as we have, well, that's not going to do it. I understand we have one more interview. Go ahead, Bob. Well, we have some difficulty with the sound, but we'll see if we can't get Bob. It looks like he's got McKenzie on there.
Gavin McKenzie here. I want to apologize to you for not giving you credit for a fumble you caused in last week's game, but okay. Your secondary just does a great job.
Yes, you know, they work us every day, hard work and everything.
Me squad.
And all the me squad help us a lot.
Me squad right here.
Muffin, and yeah. Kenneth Jackson, and Russell Hobson, they all help us.
Okay. I know as being in the defensive secondary with you and
Ronald and Amar.
Ronald and Amar. That's got to make you feel good because you can depend on those people back there.
Yes, it helps me a lot because they helped me back there, you know. They got my back, I got their back and everything.
Well, I tell you, you guys did a great job. And it's been a long season, but the end was what it should have been, right?
Yes.
Good
yes.
enough. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah! Me squad, baby! Good work. Oh, man. You know, there are a lot of other
heroes on the team.
All right, well, that is, I think, well, no, we got one more. We have to talk to one more man. Is that right, Bob? I think we've run out of time and run out of interviewees. But, again, the final score, the Hampton Crabbers win the Group AAA Division V state champion. Okay, we got one more shot. All right, Bobby Blizzard, go ahead.
You know, great turnaround from the first of the season. The second part of the season, you have really played with a vengeance.
No, man, it took a lot of hard work from coach. Coach had helped me discipline myself to come to practice every day doing two-a-days. When I quit, my mom had to make me come back. So, because when I quit, it's in my family. So when I came back, a lot of players just, oh.
Well, I know that it's not just catching the ball. You do a good job, you got, but you also have to block, and there's other things you got to do. You play defense. If you had to pick what was the most favorite thing to do, which would it be?
Well, I like to go off of passes and stuff. Yeah. I like to go off of passes.
Well, a couple of times this year, you took the ball away from somebody else.
Yeah, well, mix up of patterns and stuff. It was my fault to mix up of patterns, though, but I just wanted the ball more, so I just took it.
There you go. Well, listen, congratulations. We'll look forward to seeing you on the basketball court.
All right.
Good. Grab on!
All right, well, I believe that was the the last interview. The final score again, the Hampton Crabbers 35, the EC Glass Hilltoppers 7. The Hampton Crabbers are the state champions for 1995. For the Channel 5 crew and Bob Hintz, this is Tim Cole, and for Bob Killen as well, thank you for watching. Good afternoon, everybody.